headphones on, so when you bring it back, when we come back.
Last played a football game of consequence here at SNU Football Stadium. And today, the Crimson Storm return home, taking on the three-time defending champion and nationally ranked Ouachita Baptist Tigers. Hi, everyone, and welcome into the broadcast booth. I'm Luke McConnell. Joining me in the booth for our third season together is Landry Franks. We'll bring him in just a moment. Last week, SNU got off to a rough start against Arkansas Monticello, trailing 30-7 at halftime. But the Crimson Storm did not give up, even when starting quarterback Gage Porter went out with an injury in the third quarter. The defense pitched a shutout, and backup quarterback Jarvis Davis led the offense admirably. The Crimson Storm trailed 30-23 with just under 3 minutes left when they began a potentially game-tying drive, but the effort fell just short. It's the first home game for new head coach Dustin Hayden, and he's got a roster stocked with players who are young by classification, but veterans in their time together and on campus. The question is, can the Crimson Storm carry over the momentum from the second half of last week into today's game against the Tigers? And Landry, a tough start in that first half last week, but the second half gave you lots of good things to look forward to here this afternoon.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. You can't ask to finish a game better than that. You know, they had two chances in the fourth quarter even to take the lead back. So a tremendous second half. I know Coach was happy about that and the way that they showed effort and some motivation in kind of a tough situation where they could have lied down. But if you think about it, Luke, it was a 14-7 game with 11 minutes and 53 seconds left in the second quarter of that game. 14-7, and then with 3 minutes and 45 seconds left, the score had ballooned to 30-7. So you take away really 3 drives, and that game is a much different story, but certainly the second half they gave great effort.
And you know, this has been a strange 18 months or so for Coach Hayda since he took over the program. You know, just 3 months into his tenure, COVID hits, spring practice is halted. You go through into the fall, uncertainty of if you're going to play, and then you end up not playing. Then you play the 4 games in the spring. But he's mentioned multiple times that this time has been invaluable for him and his coaching staff to establish a culture. And, you know, having been there yourself on an SNU roster, what's it like to be able to focus exclusively on culture without even having to worry about games?
Yeah, absolutely. Well, we're talking about, in a lot of ways, small school football. You know, you're not gonna be playing in front of 20,000 fans or anything like that. But what you're gonna do is you're gonna have lots of opportunities to get on the field and to play. And as a coach, you want the best character on the field in situations like this, where maybe you're only playing in front of a few hundred fans. You want the guys who can motivate themselves and get ready to go. But then you think you have 2 years to teach the disciplines that you want them to learn to play the game well. So you get to teach fundamentals, you get to teach all these things, but they get to do it in a community of football players, which is very unique. You know, I know Coach was excited about having really these freshmen who are kind of double freshmen who've had a year to sit under that kind of culture building, and a lot of them played well last week.
And the roster, such a weird influx kind of thing. He said about 75 quote-unquote freshmen, that mm-hmm. would be true freshmen, redshirt freshmen from 2019 that right. redshirted, plus the COVID freshmen who came in the fall or last fall, didn't get to play, but are still classified as true freshmen. So 75 of those, plus you've got 18 graduate players mm-hmm. on the roster, 8 playing their final fall, 10 who have 2 more. So such a fascinating roster mix-up as well.
Yeah, absolutely. And you could see it out there. You could see some of those quote-unquote freshmen, whether they were truly freshmen or redshirt freshmen or COVID freshmen, however you want to classify them. You know, their skill showed on the field. Now, there were, obviously, in the first half, there was some learning curve for many of them, but they played well. And when they settled into the game, when they saw the speed, they didn't have to worry about everything else. They know the plays. They know what to do in certain situations. So I think the freshmen will be invaluable this game.
And with that, playing a very tough Ouachita team, 3-time Great American Conference champions, they are 32-5 over the last 3 seasons. Just they have set the standard here in the conference over the past few years.
Certainly. And you know exactly what you're going to get when you play Ouachita. Lots of runs. And when you think they're going to pass, they're probably just going to run some more. So SNU has to be ready for that.
Well, at this time, we're going to turn it over to our pregame conversation with SNU head coach Dustin Hayda and get his thoughts on this afternoon's game as well as wrapping up last week's game against Ouachita Baptist. Welcome into our pregame conversation with SNU head coach Dustin Hayda ahead of this afternoon's game against Ouachita Baptist. And Dustin, a tough loss on the road to start the season at Arkansas Monticello. Just your general thoughts from the game.
Well, we had that start, that slow start, and then we kind of got our act together as we went. And we've been talking a lot, you know, all week about show up ready to go and don't wait on them. Have energy from the start to make big plays and not wait on a big play to get our energy. And so that was kind of what we took away from last week, is the slow start and then the really resilient finish in the second half.
We saw Gage Porter go out in the third quarter. What's the status of him this afternoon?
It's just a bruise. So he should be golden and ready to go.
You guys face a tough test in Ouachita Baptist. What have the Tigers done in winning the past three conference championships?
They are extremely well coached, all on offense and defense. They're very consistent in what they do. They have a great identity. They know what they do defensively. They know what they do offensively, and that doesn't change very much. And so, and of course, they have great players. But the players they have are coached up very, very well, and Coach Knight does a great job running that program. And it's consistency, buy-in, coaching, and the players that they have that have really made them successful over the past however many years.
A lot of new faces on this roster, a lot of new faces contributing consistently for you guys, at least hopefully consistently. Who are some of those guys, especially the freshmen, who stood out to you last week in Monticello?
Yeah, there was quite a few guys. So Josh Lopez is kind of a super COVID freshman, led us in tackles. And Marcus Sowell on the defensive line led us in sacks. Jarrell Farr at slot receiver, I believe he was either our top receiver in catches or in yards, one or the other with Reed. We have two freshman tackles starting on our offensive line. And so they've been Andy Cardenas and David Morales are starting for us at both tackles. And so they've done an outstanding job. We're playing about three freshmen on our defensive line along with Marcus. And so it's been – those guys coming out of that COVID year have been really, really good. It was really good for them to get experience through that October, then that February, and those four games. It helped them grow up in the scheme, and you know, they've even had time physically. They're still freshmen, but they're a little bit more experienced and maybe a little more college-ready than most.
You had the four spring games, but this is your first time coaching in Bethany in front of a crowd that, you know, with a game that counts toward the Great American Conference standings. How excited are you for this opportunity?
I'm excited for our guys to play a really good opponent at home, and I'm excited for them to cut loose in front of a lot of people and friends and family and fans. And so that's where my excitement lies. Those guys are due for good outcomes, and they're excited to play with great energy and on Saturday.
And then finally, Dustin, what are some keys for your team today against Ouachita Baptist?
Well, we got to eliminate mistakes that we can control. So, you know, penalties, we've got to eliminate pre-snap penalties and defensive penalties, special teams penalties as well. We've got to be really solid on our special teams, which can be a great equalizer at times. And then we've got to possess the ball on offense and then take the ball from them on defense and special teams. So turnovers, penalties, and just overall consistency of play. And like we talked about way early is, you know, a fast start. Don't wait on a big play to bring energy. Produce that energy so that we can produce big plays.
Dustin, thank you so much for your time, and best of luck today against Ouachita.
I appreciate it.
Well, welcome back to SNU Football Stadium. Pre-game coverage continuing here on Crossover Radio Sports and the SNU Athletics YouTube channel. SNU Football brought to you on Crossover Radio Sports this season by Edmund Air Conditioning, Heating, and Plumbing. Big shout-out to our season sponsor there, Luke McConnell, Landry Franks with you again. You heard on the GAC Rewind. This is the only early game today. Everybody else opting for the cooler evening temperatures and kickoff. All 6 o'clock kicks across the board. Arkansas Tech at East Central, Harding at Southeastern, Arkansas Monticello at Oklahoma Baptist, Southwestern at Southern Arkansas, and Northwestern at Henderson State. And Landry, we left off before the pregame audio from Coach Hayda discussing Ouachita Baptist and just their run of dominance. But Oklahoma Baptist was able to find some flaws there. It is a younger team, a lot, a smattering of starters coming back on both sides of the football, but they have lost 11 all GAC performers from the 2019 season. So a little bit of flux there over across the way for the Tigers.
Yeah, and that's almost to be expected with good teams. You know, you're going to lose great players. You know, you look at their two deep roster, there's just as many freshmen as SNU this year. So you're certainly a young team, an inexperienced team, a good team. Like Coach Hayda said, you know, they have Coach Knight over there who's been there 22 years. I mean, that tells you just about everything you need to know about the consistency of that program. And they've been good for 22 years. So I don't expect them to be anything less than good today. But certainly with their younger players, they have some areas that can be exposed. As we're looking at film, there's some things that they aren't doing, like tackling as well as they have in the past. And certainly they have a lot of young linemen too, so they'll have to really make sure they block well. SNU did a great job last week penetrating the line on stretch runs, and OBU loves to run stretch runs. So there's definitely opportunities for SNU to make big plays.
We're going to run through the starting lineups here for both squads as we get count down to kickoff here in Bethany. First up on the defense for Southern Nazarene, across the defensive line, number 90, Marcus Sowell, freshman from Rockwall, Texas. Number 92, Mason Williams, freshman from Edmond. And number 46, Landon Walker, the senior from Mineola, Kansas. The linebackers, number 28, James Love, senior from Cincinnati, Ohio. Number 25, Dylan Bauer, the junior from Rowlett, Texas. Number 31, Cole Cizik, junior from Elgin, Oklahoma. And number 19, Angel Hernandez, senior from Huntington Beach, California. In the secondary, number 7, Dorian Harris, senior from Mansfield, Texas. Number 24, Trent Smith, junior from Rowlett, Texas. Number 2, Eli Calhoun, sophomore from Grand Prairie, Texas. And number 21, Cam Wells, sophomore from Texarkana, Texas. On offense, across the offensive line, as you heard Coach Hayda mention, two starting freshmen tackles. Number 77, Andy Cardenas on the left side, freshman from Mesquite, Texas. Number 62, Grayson Winters, junior from Prosper, Texas, is at left guard. The center, number 50, Joey Carrion, junior from Edinburgh, Texas. Number 67, Braden Jones, the junior from Lone Wolf, mans the right guard position. And number 73, David Morales, a freshman from Duncanville, Texas, manning the right tackle spot. At running back, number 29, Angel Ramirez, sophomore from Albuquerque, New Mexico. The quarterback, to be determined at this point. You heard in the pregame audio, Coach Hayda mentioning that Gage Porter would be good to go after suffering that third quarter injury. Pregame warm-ups, he did warm up some. Didn't look like he was throwing with the other quarterbacks the entire time. So to be determined on who comes out in that first offensive set for the Crimson Storm. So we could see Gage Porter, the junior from Elk City, or Jarvis Davis, wears number 8, the sophomore from Freeport, Texas. At the wide receiver positions, though, number 15, Jarrell Farr, freshman from Richmond, Texas. Number 4, Andrew Tisdale, sophomore from Humble, Texas. Number 18, Reed Roloff, senior from University Place, Washington. And at tight end, number 85, Jaron Alvarado, the junior from Bushland, Texas. Ryan Reed, the junior from Burleson, Texas, he wears number 99. He's handling the place kicking and the punting for the Crimson Storm. And those are your starting lineups for Crimson Storm. Landry, some players to watch today. Your guys on both sides of the ball.
Yeah, well, offensively, One of the best things about SMU's offense is they can put anybody anywhere. And if you watched any of the game last week, Darrell Farr was everywhere. He played slot. He played outside receiver. He lined up in the running back. He motioned from the slot to the running back. And they were being really creative to give him opportunities to get the ball. And there were a couple big plays that he had just because he had the ball in his hand. So I would watch out for number 15 today. He's going to get the ball a lot. And I think they're going to try to do it pretty creatively, just like they did last week. Defensively, I'm keying in on really a group of players, and that's the outside linebackers. SMU's defense in preventing the run is kind of predicated on making sure that they contain outside. So those outside linebackers have to make sure that they keep that outside arm free on these long stretch runs and don't undercut a block to try to make a play, but instead stay on the outside so they can make the play and help the middle linebackers in the secondary rally to tackle the football carrier.
All right. Offensively for me, I'm going to go with Reed Roloffs. He's wearing number 18 today. A little bit of a jersey misplacement, according to the coaching staff. But he's the same Reed Roloffs. Started the season well last week. 5 catches, 64 yards. He's been here a while, it seems like, for a very long time. He is a veteran on this squad, and they need him to be that leader. And I think that if SNU is going to find success offensively, they're going to have to go to Reed consistently today. The other guy, freshman Marcus Sowell on the defensive line at that defensive end position, had 2 sacks last week against Arkansas Monticello, part of 3 or 4 freshmen who are getting into the rotation along that defensive front. And so Marcus Sowell going to make some plays today. He has to make some plays if the Crimson Storm are going to contain this rushing attack for Ouachita Baptist.
Absolutely, absolutely. Man, Reed had some big plays, and he's just a sure hand when SNU really needs a big play. You can look for him on third downs. He's a big target who can catch the ball consistently, which is a quarterback's best friend.
Teams out there, Ouachita has won the toss. SNU will receive. They will be heading left to right as you look on your live stream feed into a very stiff south breeze. It's a warm one today as the Crimson Storm and the Tigers take the field. A great crowd here on hand in Bethany for the home opener for the Crimson Storm. But it will be a hot one, and the wind, a significant factor today, is a very stiff south breeze today.
Absolutely. Luke, I got to know, before we see the offense out there, who's quarterback?
Based on what I saw in pregame warmups, it's unless it was a significant shell game, I would imagine that Jarvis Davis is the guy who goes out there first.
Yeah, certainly. In warmups, we saw Gage wearing two pairs of wide receiver gloves, which is very unique for a quarterback. Maybe he needs a better grip on the ball, but who knows? I think that at the very least, we're going to see some creative quarterback play, maybe multiple quarterbacks different times this game.
Trying to see if I can see him down there in the scrum on the sideline. He's down there at the far end. Mm-hmm. He has lost the gloves.
Okay.
But he is standing, probably reading too much into the fact that he's on the right side of the bench.
That's
when
right.
He's receiving on the left side.
Well, the gloves are coming back on right now as we speak.
So it looks like it might be Jarvis Davis who will be handling the offense to start, or at least if Gage Porter does go out there with the starting group, then it will just look significantly different. Also out for today's game, it looks like, just based on the sideline, look like Josh Johnson will not be playing today, the cornerback from Borger, Texas. But we are just about set here in Bethany as Gabe Goodman, sophomore kicker, honorable mention all GAC in 2019, the sophomore will be the kicker. Jarrell Farr and Amon Byers back deep to receive, and we are underway here in Bethany. Goodman's kick sails halfway through the end zone, and it'll be a touchback to start this one.
You'd hope it'd be a touchback with a wind like it is today.
Yeah, you just have to poke it in the air and just let it float. And it will be Jarvis Davis heading into the huddle for the Crimson Storm to start this game. So Davis, who handled the comeback in Monticello last week, will head out as the starting quarterback this afternoon for the Crimson Storm.
You know, Luke, you and I were talking about it before the game, but Jarvis looked comfortable in the pocket. They really like to get Gage Porter out on the run, but Jarvis is really comfortable underneath or just in the pocket like a stand-up passer.
Wide receiver to either side. Roll off the man in motion to the top of the formation. Davis fakes the give, gives it to Angel Ramirez. Spins off the line of scrimmage and gains about three up to the 28-yard line on first down.
Yeah, they OBU just lost a linebacker for a play, so you maybe see another run right here. His helmet came off. Ty Compton.
Tigers running a 4-3 defense. This is their base formation. They have a first teamer at defensive end, all GAC defensive end, Damian McDonald, number 56. He's on the far side. Two wide receivers left, one to the right. Alvarado motions to the left side. Davis takes the snap, gives it to Ramirez again, cuts it up the middle. He's met in the hole fiercely there by number 38, Terrell Gibson, who had seven tackles a week ago. It'll bring up third down and seven for the Crimson Storm.
Yeah, SMU loves to run really what they call kind of a gut play where they pull a guard or two guards. They can do that with a quarterback, running back, even on a slot, like an H coming across the formation. But if the guards miss it, it's hard to hit. So those pulling guards have to connect with the first defender they see.
Ball on the right hash, two wide receivers to the left. Alvarado across the formation. Now back to the left side, Davis in the shotgun. He's back to pass. Flag comes out. Tried to hit far on the crossing route. And it falls incomplete, and I think we're going to get an illegal formation here on the Crimson Storm. So that penalty will be declined, and a three and out for SNU to start this one. And Ryan Reed will come on to kick into a very strong south breeze. Reed last week, 43 yards per kick with a long of 50. And back deep to receive for the Tigers is freshman Connor Flanagan, who had one punt return last week for 19 yards against Oklahoma Baptist. And the officials stop play here.
Yeah, this punt, these are the kind of a nightmare punts for a punter because into the wind, a strong wind, you really want to hang it up there, but it's coming backwards if you do that. So it'd be interesting to see if he kind of drives it on this punt.
Alvarado is the long snapper for the Crimson Storm. Gives it back to Reed. Reed, a low one, kind of knuckled, bounces at the 50 and will roll all the way down inside the 40-yard line, all the way to the 36 of Ouachita.
Luke, you didn't ask me my special teams player of the week last week, but it was Alvarado, the long snapper and tight end. He had two amazing open field tackles on punt as a long snapper. Because no one blocked him. But OBU this week double-teamed him, first punt of the game. So apparently they were watching film and trying to block him so that they can get their man free.
So Landry, last time these two teams met, it was equally windy but significantly colder
yes.
than weather. It
yes.
was a miserable night to be out on the field. But SNU jumped out to a 13-0 lead, and
yeah.
the Tigers eventually kind of ground SNU down just 25 yards in the second half for the Crimson Storm in that game. But I mean, just you haven't seen any semblance of success. And the past two times here, in fact, have been pretty close. 21-14 was the score here in 2017, and that final score in 2019 was 27-13. In Arkadelphia, bit of a different story.
Right.
But here in Bethany, it's been fairly tight the past couple years.
Yeah, making the trip to Bethany on a Saturday, especially a hot day, you know, if you're the away team, it's not something you want to do, drive to Oklahoma City to play in the heat. So certainly an advantage to SNU. But SNU really does, at home, generally plays well against the run. And like we've said, OBU loves to run the football.
Tigers come out, bunch formation on the right hash. Man in motion is Hayden Waller. The give is to T.J. Cole off the right side, who's belted at the 40-yard line. I believe that was Eli Calhoun coming up from his safety spot. Game of about five is what they're going to give him on first down, so it'll be second and five from the 41-yard line. Tigers quickly with the snap. Give it to Cole off the right side. He runs over Calhoun this time, and picks up the first down up to the 48-yard line.
Yeah, nothing fancy here. Two just power runs right into the teeth of the defense.
Tigers moving quickly here. Definitely not prone to throw the ball a lot, but two wide receivers to the left this time. Give is to Cole on a stretch play to the left. Cuts it up the middle. Breaks through the defense and finally tackled from behind by Holden Hill, but not before a gain down to the 38-yard line. A gain of 14 yards. And the Tigers quickly on the move here in the first quarter.
And that's their bread and butter, just a stretch play. And the left guard and left tackle for OBU just got better leverage on the defensive end and the outside linebacker for SNU.
Two wide receivers to the right, tied in on either side of the offensive line. From the left hash is Grant Allen, the sophomore. He gives to T.J. Cole, running right, and he's going to be taken down. Flags flying everywhere. Nice tackle there by DeMarcus Hawkins.
That might be the easiest hold we see all day, Luke.
Probably so, but a nice job there by the junior from Monterey, California. Junior college transfer from Harbell Community College. So the holding penalty on Ouachita will move it back 10 yards. And Landry, a whole different look to this defensive line this year.
Yeah, absolutely. Man, it seems like a whole bunch of new faces. And certainly almost a little bit more aggressive up front with the front three. Like I mentioned, they have done a great job of penetrating the first line of offensive blocking.
Two wide receivers either side. It's Kendall Givens in the backfield to the left of Allen. Allen back to pass. Blitz comes from Angel Ramirez. Allen gets away, scrambling to the outside, and gets out of bounds at the 42-yard line. Flags everywhere once again. And I believe we're going to get another hold on the Tigers.
Absolutely, and who's held on that play again? Landon Walker. Landon Walker's just almost running free past his man, and I believe it's a left guard, 68, who has no choice but just two plays in a row tackle him.
Landon Walker, of course, a baseball player here at SNU. Came onto the football team in 2019, and all he did was lead the team in tackles for loss and sacks. Six tackles for loss and four sacks, and had a couple very disruptive plays on DeMylan Brown last week. Didn't quite get home for a sack, but laid some wood on him if you want to go back and watch the tape. So it's now first and 30 for the Tigers back at their own 42-yard line as they shift the formation to the left side. Wide receiver either side, Givens is the back. Give is to Givens, jumps over the line of scrimmage, taken down by Cam Wells after a gain of six up to the 48-yard line.
You know, one of the things Coach Hayda said when we talked to him earlier this week is that they just need to focus on tackling. It seems so fundamental, Luke, but a team like OBU that's just going to run the ball. First and 30, they're going to run the ball. Second and 26, they're going to run the ball. Tackling really does matter to hold them to a 3- or 4-yard gain or a 10- or 15-yard gain.
Ouachita spreads it out. Two wide receivers either side. Givens remains the back as Allen checks at the line of scrimmage. Blitz coming from Hernandez off the right side. Allen looking down the seam. Collision there between Connor Flanagan and the SNU defender Aaron Randall. And a flag is going to be coming in for pass interference on Aaron Randall. And that's a tough penalty there for the Crimson Storm as it was second and 24, but the 15-yard penalty will give an automatic first down for the Tigers.
Yeah, certainly deflating. Second and 25 to first and 10.
And interesting there, it appears that pass interference is a spot foul in this situation. That appears to be a rule change. Or here comes the head linesman. He might
Something's wrong.
He might be double-checking that. So I don't think that they have made that rule change for a pass interference to be more than 15 yards. The line of scrimmage was the 48-yard line. So they're not off by much, but it would be at the 37-yard line of SNU. They got it currently spotted at the 33. So they're off by about 4 yards.
Good eye, Luke.
Yeah, because the umpire didn't run back to the line of scrimmage, and I was about to say, wait a second, is that a new rule? It wouldn't be as strange as the Oklahoma high school rule.
Oh, it's terrible.
Of holding from the spot, even if it's behind the line of scrimmage.
Yep. And
I can't believe that nobody wants to change that or fights to change it harder. Anyway, first and 10 from the 38-yard line of SNU after the pass interference. Power formation to the left side. Allen will give to Cole. Cole right up the middle, lowers his head. Still battling, trying to spin off tacklers. And he gets down inside the 30-yard line to the 29. Some fierce blocking there by Hayden Waller.
Yeah, and a good hard run. I mean, keeping his feet moving.
It's a gain of 9, second and 1 for the Tigers. 10:18 to go in the first quarter, the first drive of the game for Ouachita. Allen turns and gives it to Cole, trying to find space off the right side, tracked down from behind by Calhoun. A gain of 4 will move the chains, though, down to the 25-yard line.
Yeah, and from the secondary position, that's a really great tackle to save at least 5 yards of open field. Calhoun rushing down there and making a quick decision, making a good play.
The ball spotted on the right hash at the 25-yard line. Four tight ends in the game right now. Waller's the man in motion to the left side. Give is to Cole up the middle. Blocking, and he breaks through the line of scrimmage, and he will coast into the end zone for the 25-yard touchdown. And a flag is going to come out as Cole was showboating into the end zone, holding the ball into the air. And I don't know if that is going to wipe out the touchdown here or if it is going to be assessed on the extra point.
They move the flag back to the 3.
Before the touchdown, unsportsmanlike conduct, so that will send Cole to the sideline for a little chat with Coach Knight. I don't think it's going to be a pleasant one over there for TJ Cole.
Certainly not.
So it'll be a 15-yard penalty from the 3 is where it was marked. So they'll move it back to the 18-yard line where it will be first down and 10. It'll be first and 3 officially.
And that was just a stretch play with a cutback lane. And Hayden talked about that this week too, just being not only tackling but finding your fit. On the defense, the linebackers have to fit in those cutback lanes.
So 9:32 to go, first quarter. First and 10 inside the red zone for the Tigers. Allen gets the snap. He turns and gives it to Givens. Givens met in the hole there by Holden Hill. Eli Calhoun down there as well. And that'll be a first down to the 15-yard line. With the clock moving as we tick down to 9 minutes, SNU had the ball first, went 3 and out on their first possession. And the Tigers have been very methodical thus far. Just one attempted pass resulted in a pass interference on the Crimson Storm. First and 10 at the 15, two wide receivers to the right. Hernandez showing blitz off the right side of the line. Give us to Givens. He'll run left. He stays on his feet through a couple hits. Gets down to the 11-yard line. So pick up a 4.
Yeah, and a great kind of follow-up tackle by 31 Sizek with just hanging on, finding a leg, grabbing a toe, whatever you have to do to get him down.
Josh Lopez into the game for the Crimson Storm. Had a team-high 12 tackles last week. So that's an extra linebacker on the field. Cole, Wildcat running right, tracked down from behind by Mason Williams. A nice job there by the freshman coming down the line and making the stop after just a gain of 2. So it'll be 3rd and 4.
Gotta love the effort by the big guy. Backside of the play, comes all the way across and tackles the quick running back. Doesn't get any better than that.
Marcus Sal checking back in. As Sam Bass will come off for SNU. Excuse me, that's David Omasigo. Givens in the Wildcat. Fakes, he's running right, following Jack Pillow. Cuts inside the 5, fighting for the end zone. And he fumbled the football. It's loose on the deck. Crimson Storm says they have it. And they do! Kendall Givens fighting for the end zone, and a fumble forced on the goal line. Holden Hill comes out of there with it. There's an SNU player down at the goal line who's slow to get up. It's Cole Cizik as he'll jog off under his own power. But the Crimson Storm, after a long drive by the Tigers, forced the turnover at the one-yard line. And just like that, Landry, a huge momentum swing in this one.
Well, and we talked about, OBU's got a lot of young players too, and certainly they had a freshman running back in who has played really well. They love that Wildcat formation. But what do freshmen do? Sometimes they stick the ball out before they get to the end zone.
So Jarvis Davis back out there, running back to either side. Two wide receivers right, one to the left. SNU obviously needs to be careful here with their backs against the wall. Checks at the line of scrimmage, three on the play clock. And he's not going to get it off in time. And that's going to be a delay of game on the Crimson Storm. So they'll back it up 6 inches.
Yeah, if that. If you're OBU's running back coach,
oh,
right, they're
going to give a timeout okay. to the Crimson Storm here. And we're going to take timeout as well. So with 7:29 to go here in the first quarter, we are scoreless here in Bethany. We'll be back after this.
At SNU, we recognize the sacrifices made by our nation's veterans and their families. Whether you're looking to move up in the ranks or start a new career, we have degree options and support systems in place that will help you find success during and after college. SNU has a team dedicated to helping you make the most of your VA benefits for education and the post 9/11 GI Bill. Together, we'll find the academic support you need and connect you to support groups in your local community, whether you study on campus or online. Going back to school can be a streamlined, rewarding process. Let us show you how. To learn more, visit pgs.snu.edu/veterans.
Welcome back to Bethany. SNU and Ouachita Baptist scoreless here with 7.5 minutes to go in the first quarter. SNU just forced a fumble. 1st and 10 at the goal line. Davis trying to get out. He fumbled the football, and it's recovered by the Tigers for a touchdown. Big number 99 for the Tigers, Rovell Carter, the freshman from Shreveport, grabbed the football at the one and fell into the end zone for the touchdown.
Yeah, it's unfortunate. It looked like Jarvis saw an opening and was just so worried about getting out of the end zone. He was a little careless with the ball out to his side, and just one punch from a big defensive end, and ball bounced right into the end zone, into the waiting arms of an OBU player.
Gabe Goodman on to attempt the extra point. It's up, it's low, and it's off the upright, and no good. That sequence looked a little disjointed.
Yeah, bad snap, bad hold, bad kick, kind of all three together. The ball got there, not well.
It wasn't pretty, even if it would have gone in.
Yes, yeah, it wasn't great.
So we'll keep it here with the Tigers now leading 6-0, 7:22 to go in the first quarter. And Landry, wild momentum swing there.
Yeah.
You're kind of getting ground down on the drive, then you get the turnover, then you turn it back over for a score.
Right.
And got to handle the emotions of the ebbs and flows like that.
Yeah, certainly. And those plays are going to happen. Fumbles are going to happen, and getting the ball on the 1 yard line is never easy. But I think the thing that you do have to manage is as a defense, even though you're not going back on the field, defensively you just cause the fumble at the 1 yard line. You stop the touchdown just to be on the sidelines and watch someone score a touchdown, and that's frustrating. And so how does a defense respond? Certainly the offense has an opportunity here to get the ball back, but when the defense is on the field again, are they going to be gassed, their head going to be down, or are they going to have the momentum that they had the second half of last week's game where they really played well and got really past the line of scrimmage and made tackles in the backfield? So we'll see. It'll be interesting. We haven't seen Gage yet. I wonder if we see some Gage this play. He seems to be in the huddle right now. but so does Jarvis. So we'll see what they do.
So it'll be Goodman to kick it away for the Tigers. Byers and Farr back deep for the Crimson Storm. SNU had some decent success in the kick return game last week. Farr had a 31-yard kick. And Byers had a 23-yarder, one of his five returns. Goodman using a holder, not even trying to hold it up in this one, and he sends it high. It's going to be returnable. It's going to carry at the goal line. Farr ran up to the five, and then it just kept on floating behind him.
Well, it looked like from here, too, it's going to be short of the goal line, but it's very windy. Ball do what it wants. Best on a day like this to let it go in the end zone sometimes.
So the Crimson Storm getting technically their third crack at it on offense.
Yes, technically.
For all intents and purposes, we might as well call it the second. But
yes, because I think this next snap will be their sixth play. So
Fifth play. Three and out on their first possession. And then with the ball at the 1 yard line, the fumble recovered in the end zone by Rovell Carter. So Jarvis Davis, the quarterback, roll off to the right side. Andrew Tisdale and Aaron Fellows, and it's Fellows on the sweep. He's cut down out there at the 25-yard line by number 27, Gregory Jr., the senior from Crossett, Arkansas. Fellows, a freshman from Alpine, Texas, had 3 catches for 8 yards a week ago. It'll be 2nd and 10.
Yeah, and this is a really common play for SNU, just a jet sweep. But Fellows had a kind of an inside seam, and Reed Rolos was holding onto his block on the outside, the guy who made the tackle. Just a long time to block someone, so you'd think they want him to cut it up a little bit earlier.
Ball on the left hash, Rolos the man in motion. Davis takes the snap, looks that way, screen pass out to Fellows. He's got blockers in front of him, and a nice job cutting through all the traffic is Hayden Lassiter for the tackle, a gain of 4. On 2nd down, it'll be 3rd and 6. And Landry, a great opportunity there. Had 3 blockers in front. Yep. The safety coming over made the play.
Yeah, I mean, that's a great play. It really is, because it was well blocked and there was space. If he gets to the outside, there's plenty of opportunity to run. And this is, again, a play that is SNU's bread and butter. They run bubble to the boundary all the time in different formations of different people. So we'll see it again, and hopefully we get the same kind of blocking matchup.
So 3rd and 6, Roloffs to the top of the formation. Davis fakes, looking for Alvarado on the screen, but missed him badly. It falls incomplete as Davis was planted on his backside there by number 54, Jerelon Burks. Big boy, 5'11", 300, the freshman from Ruston, Louisiana. So that'll be a 3 and out for the Crimson Storm, and it'll bring Ryan Reed on to punt once more. Reed went 36 yards into the wind his first punt. Here with 5:53 left in the first quarter, trailing 6-0. Sends a nice booming punt, get decent spiral, sends Flanagan back to his 30. He fields it, and he'll take a knee at the 27-yard line, which is interesting. He had nothing but space.
Well,
but
I think
definitely no blockers.
It seemed like he called for a fair catch before the ball flew over his head. So as soon as he touched it, the play was dead. But yeah, green grass all in front of him.
So it'll be 1st and 10 for the Tigers at their own 27-yard line. 5:44 to go, first quarter. 6-0 Ouachita with the lead. Luke McConnell and Landry Franks here with you for the home opener for the SNU Crimson Storm. Grant Allen at the quarterback position. TJ Cole back in for the Tigers. Cole sidesteps, is cut down by Cam Wells and Eli Calhoun. Just a gain of 1 on the right side, and a great job there by those two secondary players.
Absolutely, and you have to know, as a secondary player, you've got to love a game like this where you get to run downhill every play just about. Again, we've only seen 1 passing attempt by OBU.
Yep.
And so if you're a secondary player, yeah, they have 3 or 4 tight ends on the field at a time, but you're not too worried about them.
Second and 9 from the 28-yard line, coming up on 5 minutes to go in the first quarter. Stretch play to the left. It's Zaylin Falls, and he's grabbed from behind. That's Josh Lopez, who held on to him long enough to let the cavalry get there. Just a gain of 2 up to the 31. Trent Smith has to come off as he lost his helmet. Josh Lopez, one of those freshmen who Dustin Hayden raved about in the spring, called him one of their most physical players on the entire roster.
Oh, and you can tell. You can tell he has a nose for the football, and he's certainly in on every play, and he's not afraid to make tackles, even tough tackles like that.
So two wide receivers either side, 3rd and 6 from the 31-yard line. Cole is the back to the right of Allen. Allen back to pass. Looking to the right side, he's got Waller, and he stretches over Holden Hill across the 38-yard line for the first down. Caught it short of the sticks, but was able to have enough space to get across the line to gain before Hill was able to get over there. So first down for the Tigers.
And their second pass, and it wasn't pretty. You know, they have the wind with them right now, and that pass almost sailed over the head of their tight end.
Now wide receiver either side. Shift two tight ends to the right side of the formation. Now Waller comes in to join them. The give is to Cole right up the middle. Met in the hole by Lopez. Trent Smith came in to finish the play off. It's a gain of 3 up to the 41. But again, Lopez, a physical collision there in the hole.
Absolutely. And these are the fits that Hayden was talking about, right? Finding those cutback lanes, especially with a team who loves to cut back with their quick running backs, just fitting into those holes and worrying about your job, making sure that you're making the tackle, wrapping up, and then letting people rally around you.
Tigers coming up on 100 yards rushing here in the first half. Allen, play action fake. He's got a wide open receiver down the middle. It's Hunter Swoboda. And he gets all the way down to the 35-yard line. So a big gain there for the junior from Bentonville. Averaged 28 and a half yards per reception a season back in 2019. Just 5 catches, but the nearly 30 yards a pop led the conference in yards per reception.
You think 5 catches might have led the OBU in total catches that season.
Quick pitch ahead to Connor Flanagan around the right side. And, oh, Josh Lopez just tripped him up. Flanagan was heading for pay dirt there.
Absolutely.
But he gets down to the 27, a gain of 8.
And that does count as a pass, Luke.
It does. It does indeed. Speaking of receptions, we got to remember that the Tigers are lost their all-everything slot receiver, Allie Freeman, who had 95 receptions in 2019. And still averaged less than 10 yards a catch. That tells you how they used him. Everybody in tight here on the left hash, 2nd and 2. Allen turns and gives to Cole. Right up the middle, met in the hole. A short gain, but it's enough to move the chains. As that was David Omosayo on the tackle. So a gain of 3 down to the 24-yard line. It'll be a first down for Ouachita.
Yeah, and SNU playing much better on this drive in the run game, but it's been those play-action fakes that have really bit them this drive.
Cole in the Wildcat formation here. He's running left, following the blocks. James Lowe with a nice tackle off the edge, crashing in, and got some help from Milik Ritchie and Mark DeMarcus Hawkins. And Landry, James Love, number 28 for the Crimson Storm at that outside linebacker position. 7th year. Graduated high school in 2014. He's been here in Bethany since 2016. He is the journeyman, the old man, if you will, on this roster.
That's right. By 2022, he'll have his PhD.
Exactly. Now it's Kendall Givens in the Wildcat. Student body right, following his blockers, met in the hole, bounces off tacklers, but Angel Hernandez cleans that one up. Gain of just 1 to the 23-yard line, and Todd Knight's going to take a timeout. We are going to take timeout as well, and we will come back with 48 seconds to go in the first quarter. A key third down coming up for Ouachita right after this break. This is SNU Football, presented by Edmund Air Conditioning, Heating, and Plumbing. Welcome back to Bethany. Third down and 9 for the Crimson Storm. Allen back in at quarterback for the Tigers. And a key third down here. Allen back to pass. Looking right now. Looking left. Down the middle. He's got his man. It's Tucker Swoboda down to the 10-yard line. And a first down. But a flag in the backfield is bringing it back. A holding on the Tigers.
Hey, Luke, I'll give you one guess who they held on that play.
I'm going to guess that they held Marcus or Landon Walker.
Indeed, it looks like they did. You know, this was just a simple kind of flood concept route. So you fake the handoff one way, you come back around the other with wide receivers rolling towards the boundary. And last week, SNU had real trouble with finding the middle receiver in the flood concept, and that's exactly who OBU targeted. Their big tight end number 18, Swoboda, was just running free in that middle zone.
So now that makes it 3rd and 19. We're under 30 seconds to go in the first quarter. Three wide receivers to the left, one to the right. Allen back to pass. Looking down the right side. He's looking for Swoboda, who is grabbed by Wells. Todd Knight looking for a flag. It falls incomplete. And the Crimson Storm are going to force a fourth down here. It looked like Cam Wells from this angle got away with one there.
That's right. We're further away than that official was, but it looked like there might have been a hand or two before the ball got there.
Fortunately, it was one of those where it might have just been luck of the placement of the officials on the backside. Couldn't see the hand right in the chest, but SNU will take it either way.
Absolutely.
It'll send Gabe Goodman on for a 50-yard field goal with 14 seconds to go in the quarter. Snap is rolled out to Goodman, and it's going to fall woefully short as he couldn't get it. And the holder, Hayden Lassiter, not pleased with the long snapper out there, who's actually not on the roster. Maybe that tells us something. But anyway, so SNU, after all of that, holds once more with no points offensively for the Tigers thus far, and they'll take over first and 10 at the 33-yard line. 9 seconds to go in the first quarter.
And you think we're going to see a run here and get to the end of the first quarter.
Maybe a home run ball or two. See how many plays you can squeeze in 9 seconds.
Yeah, into the wind. Deep pass.
Christian Schellmeyer out there in the running back slot. His first action of the day. They'll line up behind Jarvis Davis. Two wide receivers right, one to the left. Farr, the man in motion, stops. Give is to Javis. Will keep it around the right side. Great blocking outside by Dalton Sanders. He'll cross midfield into Ouachita territory with 2 seconds to go in the first quarter. And a big play on first down. And that will bring us to the end of the first quarter here in Bethany. After one, our score, Ouachita Baptist 6, SNU 0. We'll be back after this. This is SNU Football, brought to you by Edmund Air Conditioning, Heating, and Plumbing. Start of the second quarter here in Bethany, Ouachita. Baptist trailing, or leading SNU rather, 6-0. First and 10 SNU. Jarvis Davis back to pass is batted in the air and it falls incomplete. He was looking for roll-offs down the seam, who was covered nicely there by the Tigers. So it'll be 2nd and 10 for the Crimson Storm.
That's probably one, if you're the offensive coordinator, you're a little pleased that it got batted down at the line of scrimmage. Throwing in the double covers there, but like we were talking about right before kickoff, Davis seems comfortable sitting back there, standing tall in the pocket, where they like to put Porter on the run. Really the first passing attempt we've seen from him today, sitting tall in the pocket, stepping up, making the throw.
Davis, one of those guys, sophomore by classification due to COVID and everything, and he fakes the give to Farr, running left. He'll keep it up the middle. Flag comes down as Davis is spilled at the 46-yard line. We'll see what the flag is for. It is going to be a hold on SNU. Dustin Hayden not pleased with it, asking for a hold on the defensive lineman.
Yeah, it didn't look like maybe there was some mutual holding, but didn't seem to warrant a flag.
So it'll be 2nd and 20 now from SNU's own 41-yard line. We're just underway into the second quarter. Ouachita Baptist trailing or leading 6-0, 14:30 to go before halftime. Luke McConnell, Landry Franks with you here at SNU Football Stadium. Two wide receivers left, one to the right. Davis rolling left, looking outside just off the hands of Farr, just a little out of his reach. Might have been deflected there as well by Ty Compton on the rollout. He came up holding his head in his hands. So it'll be 3rd and 20 now, and with this SNU offense, Landry not exactly on schedule.
No, you can see they're kind of out of rhythm. They've only really had one play that netted more than about 4 yards, and it was just the quarterback run by Davis, which was a good play, a little speed option with a seam there, but just don't seem to be in rhythm. Timing, even on the motions that they do every play, seem just a little bit off.
And now we're going to get a timeout here from Dustin Hayda, as offense wasn't able to really get things organized. And Landry's been kind of an uneven first half thus far, not just in the plays, number of plays run on either side, but just the general feel of it. It's just been back and forth. You've got Ouachita, who's been able to move the ball down the field, mm-hmm. but no points to show for it offensively. Meanwhile, SNU hasn't had the ball very much, but they were able to get the big play by Jarvis Davis, but now face a 3rd and 20 and the prospect of putting, you know, a defense that's getting ground down a little bit back on the field.
Yeah, and that's the real problem. It's defensively, they're playing well, but how many times can you go out there and stop a stretch run before a hole kind of busts loose? So, and defensively, they've been bailed out too by some penalties from OBU. But there's opportunities for them to make some plays, and this 3rd and 20 certainly could be one of those opportunities.
Farr and Sanders to the left, roll-offs to the right. Davis, straight drop back, looking down the sideline, and he airmailed Jarrell Farr, who looked like he ran a post concept, and Davis thought he was running a go pattern, and Davis, with the wind, was able to fling that one.
Yeah, you could.
Long way.
Yeah, and he kind of needed to. The pressure was coming. The pocket was closing in around him. There wasn't anywhere to step up, and so sometimes you just launch that thing just to avoid the sack. So the first quarter was a punter's nightmare. Second quarter is a punter's dream. Punting into this wind, you got to love it.
Flanagan standing back at the 12-yard line. Reed back to punt. Sends this one high. Flanagan calls for a fair catch at the 15-yard line. So it'll be a kick of 44 yards. And Ouachita Baptist will come back on offense here with 14:03 to go before halftime. Still just a 6-0 game. The Tigers over 100 yards on the ground thus far this afternoon. But no points to show for it offensively. Their lone touchdown, a fumble recovery in the end zone by Rovell Carter, one play after SNU had forced a fumble by Kendall Gibbons as he was going into the end zone for a score.
When you think about it, after that drive that they fumbled on the one-yard line, they haven't had much success running the football. They really haven't. What their plays, I mean, the way they marched down the field the last drive was play action. And kind of just, I think they had a play action boot, play action tight end dump, a little out route to wide receiver. It wasn't their bread and butter that is getting them down the field. But I would anticipate that they're going to keep running stretch run and zone and power to try to wear this front line of SNU, who's played really well, try to wear them down in this second quarter.
Crimson Storm offensively thus far, just 23 yards according to our stats here. The Tigers at 140, averaging 6.7 yards per play. SNU at just 2.1 yards per play thus far. Really, penalties have been the biggest hindrance for Ouachita thus far. Four penalties, 45 yards. Three of them holds, and then one, a personal foul, unsportsmanlike conduct that took a touchdown off the board.
That's right. And those three holds were necessary.
Yes, they were. So first and 10 for the Tigers at their own 15-yard line, moving left to right. Allen gives it to Cole. Cole trying to find some space on the right side. Finally broke through the middle of the line. Gained 5 yards. They're going to give him the 21. So 6 yards on first down.
Just a power play there. And it's just patient running. Just patient running. Cole does a good job of going to his first read and then slowing down and seeing the cutback lane and following his guard.
So second and 4 for the Tigers. Quick pitch to Kamontre Knight, and he is knocked down by his own lineman, who is pushed into him by big number 93 for SNU, Cam Flowers, the redshirt freshman from Sash, Texas. So it's a loss of 2 on the play.
Yeah, that's not a highlight that that left guard wants to remember, getting pushed into his own running back by the defensive lineman. But a great play by Flowers. Man, just a great effort, good strength to try to get to the ball, even though he's got a lineman right in front of him.
And once again, freshman, redshirt freshman, you see it. You're seeing it a lot here today. Right now, you've got 4 freshmen or redshirt freshmen out on the defensive line as SNU's going to burn a timeout here defensively. And that was the right guard, Hunter Jackson, who's the lone senior on this offensive line for Ouachita. They bring back 3 out of their 5 linemen from the 2019 GAC Conference Champions. And Landry, they've won 28 straight conference games over the past 3 seasons. Again, we mentioned 32-5 over their last 3 years. Todd Knight in his 22nd season really has this program humming.
Yeah, you win 28 conference games. I mean, this is a tough conference. It's not like every game is a piece of cake. To win 28 conference games consecutively just shows you just how established this program is. But, I mean, as we've seen today, Luke, they have some holes. They have some holes that certainly can be taken advantage of. And SNU has a great opportunity right here, 3rd and 6, to get the ball back to their offense before halftime.
12:49 to go before halftime. 6-0 Tigers. Cole is the running back with Allen. 3 wide receivers left, 1 to the right. Allen back to pass, looking left. Up the seam, he goes high, and it's incomplete, looking for Justin Dean. And it'll bring up 4th down. Trent Smith was in coverage on the play. And Justin Dean, 6'2", had to climb the ladder for that one, but still not quite tall enough.
Yeah, and this is the problem when you only pass the ball about 20 times a game. A 20-yard dig is about your limit, and you can see the quarterback just not comfortable making those throws consistently.
Didn't cross my mind. I just saw him in on the sideline there. Dorian Harris not playing today, not dressed out, so he and Josh Johnson out in the secondary. It'll be Joe Couch on to punt. That one rolls back to him. Gets up a high one. It's twisting in the wind. Roloffs is under it at the 47-yard line, where he will take a fair catch. And we will take a timeout as well with 12:37 to go before halftime. The Tigers lead the Crimson Storm 6-0. This is SNU Football, presented by Edmund Air Conditioning, Heating, and Plumbing.
Friends, family, alumni, and supporters of Southern Nazarene University, we come to you today as representatives from the Student Athletic Advisory Committee.
We're a student leadership group on campus with representatives from each of our NCAA sports. As SAC members, we are the elected voices of our teams to our administration.
We are coming to you to ask for your help for a special project.
By the end of this year, SNU will have had over 200 student athletes graduate within the past 4 years.
Receiving a degree while balancing the demands of being a student athlete means working diligently to be successful as a student and representative for our school and the kingdom.
This year, as a student group, we decided to ask our department to assist us in creating a fundraising campaign that would generate enough money
so that each student athlete who will graduate this May and next year could receive a stole to commemorate their time at SNU playing for the Crimson Storm.
We want to say thank you to our graduating seniors who have...
And welcome back to Bethany. SNU with the football at their own 48-yard line. Davis, looking outside, pitches it out to Rojas, who's met and planted in the backfield by number 2, Andrew Hayes. And Davis is fortunate that Hayes went for the tackle and not the ball there, because that could have been trouble the other way. It was trouble enough for Reed.
Yes, yeah, I was about to say. Yeah, I don't think Reed is too pleased with that, but that's some of the problem with running the speed option. I mean, he had success with it at the end of the first quarter. But that can be the danger, and Reed, really might be one of the better plays of the game, holding on to that football while getting planted.
So a loss of 4 on the play back to the 46-yard line, where it will bring up 2nd and 14, 11:50 to go before halftime, 6-0 Ouachita. And now a flag comes in, and we're going to get a delay of game penalty on the Crimson Storm. So that'll back up SNU 5 more yards to the 39-yard line.
That seemed to be kind of a problem area for in 2019 for SNU. Just not getting the ball off quick enough. They like to motion, so they need every bit of that clock, but they got to snap the ball.
Davis takes the snap, running left. Now we'll cut it back. Back across the field. Dumps it off to Alvarado. Bounces off a tackler at the 45-yard line, and we'll get close to the original line of scrimmage at the 46-yard line. So a gain of... ended up being a gain of about 6 or 7 there. So it'll be up 3rd and 12.
That's just a little a kind of a modified run-pass option. And one thing that, you know, is overlooked on a run-pass option is linemen not going downfield.
Just thinking the same thing. Fortunate there wasn't.
As soon as he threw it, that's the first thing I looked for, and the linemen stayed committed to where they needed to be.
3rd and 12. Far the man in motion to the left side. Davis looking that way. Now he'll air it out down the sideline for Far. Just overshot it. Shot the freshman. And a nice throw there from Davis. Just led him a little far out of bounds. Maybe just leave that a little bit more in the field of play.
Yep.
And it comes up wanting. It'll be 4th down for SNU with 10:36 to go before halftime.
I like the play concept. You fake the bubble or make them think you're going to run a bubble and take Far to the corner. But that throw's got to be on the money.
Ryan Reed on to punt again for SNU. Flanagan back deep. Reed sends this one high end over end. Flanagan comes up. It bounces at the 3 and goes into the end zone for a touchback with 10:27 to go in the second quarter. We'll keep it here. And Landry, the offense, once again a slow start, but this so far the defense has held their own. In one way or another, you had the missed field goal, you had the forced turnover on the goal line, and you've had some timely penalty help from Ouachita, and you've also had the excellent 3-and-out the previous possession, which might have been their best defensive series thus far.
You know, we keep saying they're going to, it looks, you know, we're worried about them wearing down, but they just keep playing better. So certainly there's some optimism.
Wide receiver either side. Allen gives to Givens in the middle. And he'll fall across the 20-yard line for about 3 yards. Eli Calhoun in on the tackle along with Dylan Bauer. That'll bring up 2nd and 7. And I think a big reason for that, SNU has been rotating a lot of bodies mm-hmm. along that defensive line. They've got some depth that they trust. And that has, I think, certainly proven beneficial thus far. Two wide receivers to the right now. Tight end on the end of the formation on the right as well. Stretch play to Givens. Trying to bounce it outside. Unable to do so. That's Landon Walker coming down the line with the tackle for loss. It's a loss of 1 back to the 22. It'll bring up 3rd down.
Man, should we already give him the play of the game? Or?
Well, let's save the second gracious. Half, but my goodness, he has been everywhere.
Well, they don't have an answer for him. I mean, they can't block him. The only thing they can do is run away from him.
So 3rd down and 8. SNU with another opportunity to get off the field with 9:15 to go in the quarter. Sal coming on the blitz, and it's Allen trying to escape. He cannot escape. It's Landon Walker who got him back at the 20-yard line.
Yeah, and Landon Walker's going to get the sack on that play, but it's Sal who really sets up that play.
We've got an injured SNU player down on the field back at the 16-yard line. I think it was Dylan Bauer who's holding that left shoulder. The trainer Michael Brobston out to attend to him. Hopefully nothing lingering there, but SNU getting off the field, another 3 and out for the Crimson Storm. And it is Dylan Bauer, the junior from Rowlett.
Yeah, and SNU is really picking on that left side of the offensive line for OBU. A little bit younger players on that side. But that play wasn't simple. It was pretty simple. They just twisted the defensive end and defensive tackles and sent one inside linebacker, Bauer, and they just outmatched, right? They're trying to block too many people, and one got free. Really, two got free and pushed them back for 4th and 10.
And it looked like Anthony Cherez, who's typically on the right side of the line, has been playing left tackle,
mm-hmm.
and then Jax Gassaway, the sophomore transfer from Arkansas State, has been in at right tackle, and Chera is 2019 first team All-GAC at that tackle position, but maybe playing a little bit out of position mm-hmm. on the left side as opposed to the right.
Absolutely. That left tackle is always harder to play.
Joe Couch on to punt for the Tigers. This is their 2nd straight punter from Australia. Couch running out to the left side. He slips down at the 11-yard line! Couch trying, he's an Australian going with the Aussie style kick, running out to the right side, and he slipped down before he was able to attempt the punt, and it will be 1st down for SNU inside the red zone at the Ouachita 11-yard line.
I know the rugby style kicking, you want to run out to the side. It looked like he was trying to cut up field to
it
run
did.
With the ball, and Turf Monster got him, but I mean, I don't know why he's running the football. There wasn't much green grass in front of him. He just needed to kick that ball away.
So SNU with a huge opportunity with 8:42 to go in the first half. 1st and 10, middle of the field. Fellows, the man in motion for SNU. Davis, back to pass. It's going to be a quarterback draw, and he ran into his own lineman, Grayson Winters. And that'll be a loss of 5 back to the 16-yard line, and it was there.
Yes, it was. But quarterback draw, you got to let that develop. You got to let that develop. So your offensive linemen are going to take a couple steps back and then push forward. And Jarvis set up for about a second, really needed that extra second to create that hole. But, man, he had nothing but red jerseys and green grass in front of him and just was a little too quick. And that's a play they love, that quarterback draw.
They do. They do enjoy that one. Two wide receivers left, one to the right. Davis fakes the give. Rolling to the right. He's all by himself out there and is going to be corralled and taken down. Loses his helmet in the process as it rolls all the way over to the wall on the far side. They mark him out at the 15-yard line. So Gage Porter will come in for this third down play as Davis has to come off. Porter did not start today. Caught a helmet on the shoulder, up under the shoulder pads against Arkansas Monticello in the third quarter. Did not play the rest of the game. Coach Hayda mentioned that they were fortunate it wasn't any sort of AC joint sprain or anything of the sort, but
yeah, certainly
seems painful enough, the bruising painful enough where he was unable to start today. But he's in there right now on third down. And it's a quarterback draw all the way. Porter trying to bounce it outside, cuts it up inside, and goes down at the 15-yard line. His helmet is ripped off by Clark Yarborough. SNU sideline not pleased with that. It certainly looked like it was legit ripped off.
Not sure how your helmet flies off when you're already tackled, but apparently the refs thought it was fine. So got a field goal here. Get some points on the board.
So it'll be Ryan Reed attempting a 32-yard field goal from the left hash. Asa Robertson is the holder. Spot kick on the way. And true. So SNU on the board with 7:10 to go in the second quarter. That makes our score Ouachita 6 and SNU 3. And Landry, disappointing you can't get the ball in the end zone from the 11-yard line, but you do get points on the board. It's still just a 6-3 game.
Yes.
Over halfway through the second quarter.
Yeah, I mean, it's a really close game. OBU is not playing as well as we're used to seeing them playing. Defensively, they seem to be kind of stunned by the defensive front that SNU is running. Having trouble blocking. SNU's doing a really good job of keeping that outside hand free, fitting in their lanes and making sure those cutback lanes aren't there. But offensively, man, if you just think, if there's just a couple more minutes taken off of some of these drives to give the defense some rest, even though they got a field goal, they were only on the field for about a minute and 15 seconds. So as a defense, even though you put them in a great position to get points on the board, and you're back out there 7 minutes to go before halftime.
Ryan Reed will kick this one away. Justin Dean and Zaylin Falls back deep to return it for the Tigers. Zaylin Falls returned the opening kickoff against Oklahoma Baptist last week for a touchdown. He is dangerous. Reed kind of squibbed that one and is going to be caught by Dean. No, muffed. Falls picks it up at the 17-yard line, cuts it back, finds a hole, cuts it back again, crosses the 35, finally wrestled down at the 42. There is a flag, couple flags on the field. I believe this one is going to be coming back. Dean ran up on that one, but with the wind, carried it right into his face.
I think it's a kind of take your pick from which hold you want to call on this one.
Looks like they're going to mark both officials from the same spot. So 10-yard penalty on the hold. Push Ouachita back to start inside their own 20-yard line with 6:59 to go in the second quarter. So they'll start it right just on the other side of their own 15. 6-3, Ouachita Baptist leading in the season opener, or excuse me, home opener for the Crimson Storm. Luke McConnell, Landry Franks with you. Delighted to be back in the booth this season. Allen remains the quarterback for Ouachita. Give is to TJ Cole. And he slips down on the cut. Trent Smith right there as well. Gain of 2 on first down. To the 17.
Maybe Cole stepped in the same hole the punter just did.
Yeah.
My goodness, a turf monster.
They're helpful if they work for you.
That's right.
So it'll be 2nd and 7 from the 18-yard line. Crimson Storm have forced 2 consecutive 3 and outs against the Tigers. And it's going to be a Wildcat here. Cole running left. Bounce it up inside. Cole sees it with a massive hit. And then Cole kept his feet and ended up back inside the 15-yard line. And so that'll go down as a loss of four back to the 14-yard line. What a hit from Cizik in the hole. And absolutely. Holden Hill, the freshman, cleaned it up.
That's right. And that's why, you know, as a defensive coordinator, you're teaching your players to rally to the football, every player, even if you're on the far side of the field, because the tackler in that play was a safety. But he made the tackle 5 yards in the backfield because he was with his head down, running towards the ball, going to help clean up that tackle.
5:45 and counting in the second quarter. Third and 11 for the Tigers. Three wide receivers to the right. Allen bobbles a snap going down the sideline, and a flag is going to be thrown on Holden Hill as he shoved Justin Dean into the sideline. That wasn't really even close, yeah. Unfortunately.
You know, he could have made the play if he turns his head around. He's there. He's in position. He's just got to trust that assignment.
SNU sideline wanting that as an uncatchable ball, but Hill didn't even let Dean even try to make a play there. It was pretty much impossible to tell.
Mm-hmm.
So that'll be a free first down for the Tigers up to the 29-yard line. .535 and counting, 6-3, Ouachita. Tight end shift to the left side of the formation. Wide receiver either side as well. Waller comes in tight now. Give us to Cole, running left, picking his spot, and gets up to the 35-yard line for a gain of 6. Marcus Sowell in on the tackle along with Aaron Randall. Bring up 2nd and 4 for the Tigers.
You know, they're doing that. They're shifting the formation. They're trying to get SNU to kind of key in on the first formation they show. Then they shift it to the other side and bring that outside receiver in. And almost every time they've run to that, surely SNU is aware of that, but it does create extra blockers.
Quick pitch in front to Flanagan, and he's going to be taken down from behind. Landon Walker again coming down the line, just a gain of 1 to the 36-yard line. It'll be 3rd and 3.
Again, backside. Defensive linemen, all of them, have been playing great backside. When they pull a guard and they run a power, if you're this backside end or tackle, you're going to have no one on you. So you chase that guard to the play. 2 or 3 times this game, the backside defensive tackle, defensive end has made the play in the backfield.
Givens is the Wildcat back for the Tigers. Dean motions to the left side, everybody in tight. Givens running right, cuts it back, and he's got space. Can he, Holden Hill catch him? 45-40, 35-30, 20, 15. Hill shoves him, and Givens managed to stay in bounds, but fell eventually down at the 8-yard line is where they're going to spot it. So a massive gain down to the SNU 8-yard line for Kendall Givens.
And that's two really frustrating third downs in a row. One, the pass interference, and then that one, 3rd and 7 with a Wildcat formation, 3rd and 4. That leads to a 50-yard run.
So first and goal for the Tigers. And Grant Allen just stays on the sideline as they've got TJ Cole in now as the Wildcat back. He'll take it running right. Bounces off a tackler at the 5 and gets inside the 5 to the 3. Eli Calhoun unable to make the play at about the 6-yard line, and Cole was able to spin off of that and get in close.
And Calhoun's in the right position. He's just got to throw those arms when he throws his body in there. Just a little bit of shoulder tackling. That can be cleaned up. Just throw your arms around the guy and bring him to the ground.
2nd and goal now. Givens, the Wildcat, back. Dean in motion to the left. Givens hesitates up the middle, patient running, and he is down at the 1. He got close, but both line judges coming in saying he was down just short. So it'll be 3rd down and goal. Givens asking the coaches to hurry up and call the same play.
Yeah, that's right. There's a quarterback's coming in, but there's almost no doubt that in the red zone in the Wildcat, 34 is keeping the ball.
2:30 to go before halftime. 6-3, Ouachita Baptist with the lead. It's 3rd and goal from inside the 1-yard line. Allen lines up in the shotgun here. There's a snap. The give is to Givens on the right side, and he's met at the goal line, but he second effort gets him in for the touchdown. So the Tiger offense finally breaks through and scores a touchdown against a stingy SNU defense thus far, and with 2:12 to go before intermission, it's now Ouachita Baptist 12 and SNU 3. Gabe Goodman on for the extra point.
Let's see if they can get a field goal through into the wind.
This one could be interesting, especially the sequence hasn't been good. Snap, hold, kick, and this one is true and perfect. So with 2:12 to go before halftime, it's now 13-3. Ouachita, we'll take a timeout and be right back. After this, this is SNU football.
Wonder where the capital A in Chick-fil-A came from? It started with grade A top quality chicken. But we believed everything, not just the food, should be grade A. A is for all the little things we do to bring you our best every day.
To me, the A in Chick-fil-A is a smile. I want to give the guests a little encouragement, maybe just a little joke that makes them laugh when they come through the drive-thru. We can stay 6 feet apart and have the best air high five.
Welcome back to Bethany. 2:12 to go before intermission. Ouachita Baptist leading 13-3. Gabe Goodman with the high kick. It's going to come down to Jarrell Farr at about the 13. He's running right up the middle, and he's planted at the 27-yard line by number 35. That's Josh Burnham, and a flag comes in after the play, and I believe it's going to be Burnham getting into the face of Farr after the tackle. The tackle itself looked clean from our vantage point, but the extracurricular face mask in the face mask, not as much.
Yeah, they tell you you can drive your body through someone when you're tackling them. You can't really step over them after you're done tackling them. So probably a 15-yard penalty right there.
Oh, and they are going to call targeting. So they're going to get Burnham for targeting on that hit. And obviously at this level of football, there is no video review.
No.
So Josh Burnham is done for the day.
That's right.
And again, Landry, from our vantage point, the hit itself looked fine.
It did. It was
maybe getting up in his face after the play that we thought the flag was going to be thrown for, but not the case.
Well, and the referee kind of towards the sideline where we're at is the one who threw it, so backside. And I'm guessing the only thing that they're going to call is leading with the crown of his helmet. So if he had his head down and hits him in his head, I mean, that's the only thing I could think of, but again, it was hard to see from our point.
Referee still talking with Todd Knight about the hit. Now, I'm not sure. I mean, I get the discussion, but at the same time, there's nothing that can be done after the call is made.
Yeah.
So first and 10 for SNU at their own 41-yard line. 2:07 to go before halftime. So good starting field position with the wind for SNU. The give is to Farr, trying to pick his way around the right side. Hesitates, cuts it across the 45 up to the 48-yard line. And a nice little creative play there by Jarrell Farr. And really one of the first successful run plays of the day for SNU.
Yeah, and that was one of the keys to the offense, right? Get the ball to Farr. Get him into space. Let him create something.
SNU, no timeouts remaining as we're under 2 minutes to go. Davis looking left. Now pocket breaks down. Tried to hit Rolos, pass a little behind him, but Rolos with the drop there. And now we've got some extracurricular activity between Joey Kirion and Clark Yarborough, and a flag comes out. So we'll see which way the flag goes. Yarborough's quite displeased
yes.
over there. We'll see which way the officials rule this.
Yeah, and you know, it could go either way. It looked like they were both equally giving.
And they're going to give them each an unsportsmanlike conduct penalty. Of course, you get two unsportsmanlike conduct penalties. So it'll be third down. No penalty yardage will be assessed.
Yeah, that's probably the right call, you know.
Yeah, I agree.
Unless it's egregious, you just tell them both to stop and move on.
So third and two for SNU at their own 49-yard line. 1:40 to play in the half. Down by 10, 13-3. Roloffs, the man in motion, ball on the left hash. Davis takes the snap. He's back to throw. He's going to air it out deep again, looking for Roloffs down the sideline, and he well overshot him. And an interesting decision there with the ball near midfield with the wind at your back and a quality kicker in Ryan Reed.
Mm-hmm.
So now you're going to punt the ball away with 1:33 to go and give the ball back to the Tigers.
Yeah, and they have two timeouts. Plenty of time to, even though they don't pass the ball well, two timeouts get you some if you have a decent return here.
Flanagan will be back to receive. Ryan Reed on for his fifth punt of the afternoon, averaging 44 yards a boot thus far. Standing at his 35, Flanagan back at his own 10. Reed will send it away. End over end, it hits at the 4 and will bounce into the end zone for the touchback. So with 1:25 to go before halftime, SNU back out on the field on defense. And remember, the Tigers will get the ball to start the second half mm-hmm. as SNU started the game with the football and went 3 and out. So a key big series here for SNU to certainly prevent any more points,
right.
But if nothing else, get off the field quickly.
Yeah, minute 25, you're just telling your guys to make tackles. Just make sure you make the tackle. Don't bust on coverage. They're going to throw it. Just be ready to make a tackle, rally around the football, and let's get into halftime with the score the same.
Two wide receivers to the left. Allen gives to Falls in the backfield. Runs through one tackle. Cizik, the second man out there to make the tackle after a gain of two.
Yeah, and that's the first time we've seen Falls at the running back position today.
Falls was, again, excellent on special teams last week. Also had six carries for 20 yards. The kickoff return for a touchdown on the opening kickoff earned him Special Teams Player of the Week.
Absolutely.
In the conference.
Probably that juke he put on the kicker, too.
Yeah. So second down and 8. Ouachita in no hurry here. 45 seconds to go in the half. Allen again turns and gives to T.J. Cole right into the middle of the line. Spun off a tackle and gets up to the 30-yard line, and that'll be enough for a first down.
Yeah, that's that same play we've seen probably 10 times today. Shift to the boundary, motion the wide receiver in tight, run power straight to all the people you have lined up to block.
Clock running, 20 seconds to go in the half. 15 on the play clock. This might be the last play of the half, given Ouachita's urgency level here. Cole, right into the teeth of defense, came out the other side, was decked by Aaron Randall. And that will be how the half ends. So the Crimson Storm trailing Ouachita Baptist 13-3 at the end of the first half. Landry, just your quick thoughts, initial thoughts after the first 30 minutes.
Yeah, they're playing hard. And when we talked to Haida this week, I mean, he was adamant that they got to have the juice themselves to play hard. And it seemed like they didn't have that last game in the first half. But kind of were self-motivated in the second half. They're playing hard. Offensively, they have to find some kind of rhythm. And you wonder if maybe the loss of Gage Porter or him not playing right now might have an impact in just to that natural rhythm of an offense. It just looks a little out of sync. There's opportunities We've had drop passes from sure-handed read roll-offs. I mean, things that you think would be kind of clear, but just got to find a rhythm and get some points on the board, get the ball moving down the field.
So we'll go ahead and take an extended break here, and when we come back, we'll have first half stats analysis, get you ready for the second half of action. Again, our score at halftime here in Bethany, Ouachita Baptist 13, Southern Nazarene 3. We'll be back after this break. This is SNU Football, brought to you by Edmund Air Conditioning, Heating, and Plumbing.
Friends, family, alumni, and supporters of Southern Nazarene University, we come to you today as representatives from the Student Athletic Advisory Committee.
We're a student leadership group on campus with representatives from each of our NCAA sports. As SAC members, we are the elected voices of our teams to our administration.
We are coming to you to ask for your help for a special project.
By the end of this year, SNU will have had over 200 student athletes graduate within the past 4 years.
Receiving a degree while balancing the demands of being a student athlete means working diligently to be successful as a student and representative for our school and the kingdom.
This year, as a student group, we decided to ask our department to assist us in creating a fundraising campaign that would generate enough money
so that each student athlete who will graduate this May and next year could receive a stole to commemorate their time at SNU playing for the Crimson Storm.
We want to say thank you to our graduating seniors who have represented our university well on and off our respective stages and throughout the community.
Thank you for your support.
Thank you.
Thank you for supporting SNU Athletics.
Thank you for supporting your Crimson Storm.
Thank you. Thank you for all your support.
At SNU, we recognize the sacrifices made by our nation's veterans and their families. Whether you're looking to move up in the ranks or start a new career, we have degree options and support systems in place that will help you find success during and after college. SNU has a team dedicated to helping you make the most of your VA benefits for education and the post 9/11 GI Bill. Together, we'll find the academic support you need and connect you to support groups in your local community, whether you study on campus or online. Going back to school can be a streamlined, rewarding process. Let us show you how. To learn more, visit pgs.snu.edu/veterans.
Welcome back to Bethany. It's halftime here at SNU Football Stadium as the Crimson Storm trailing Ouachita Baptist 13-3. Luke McConnell, Landry Franks with you this afternoon for the home opener for the Crimson Storm as they come into today's game off of last week's 30-23 loss to Arkansas Monticello. Ouachita, of course, 1-0 this season after a 38-31 win over Oklahoma Baptist last week. You enjoy the sound of the storm here at halftime. And Landry, a tough first half for the Crimson Storm offensively, but as we, you know, kind of evaluate this team and the changes from the last time we saw them in games of consequence in 2019, The defense just a totally different animal. And you know, one of the things that we talked with Coach Hayda about was just from the first game, and I get apples, it's not apples to apples, right. 2 years is a big difference.
Yes.
But Arkansas Monticello ran for 340 yards against SNU 2 years ago. Last week, they ran for 113.
Yeah.
And it's a massive difference along the defensive front, and we have seen that today. While Ouachita has put up big numbers on the ground in the first half, officially 184 rushing yards with, you know, 50 of that coming from Kendall Gibbons on that one long run, but still, SNU has done very well up front.
Yeah, I mean, when you think about the amount of drives that OBU has had, they have done well just limiting this really explosive OBU run game to minimal gains consistently, forcing a few three and outs, getting the offense the ball repeatedly, had a turnover right before the end zone. I mean, they're playing really well, and Hayda was right. You know, they're playing with effort, and that's what you got to ask when you're playing the 11th best team in the country. Just have effort, give effort.
Offensively, SNU hasn't been able to get anything consistently. Had the one long run from Jarvis Davis being really the lone highlight for the offense thus far this afternoon. But, you know, Jarvis Davis started the game at quarterback instead of Gage Porter. Yeah. Porter still dealing a little bit with the lingering effects of that hit he took last week in Monticello. But what do you think has been the main issue thus far for the Crimson Storm offensively?
Yeah, it's hard to pinpoint. You know, I'm sure the offensive coordinator, I'm sure Hayda is well aware of some of the things that are wrong. But just to me, and Luke, I'd love to hear your thoughts too, but just to me, it seems like they're just a little, just about a half second off on everything. So third and three on the last possession, or maybe second and three, they just throw a little stop route, kind of a slant stop route to Reed Roloff's, their most consistent receiver. Ball's just a little bit behind. Reed could have caught it, drops it a little bit. It just looks a little out of rhythm, out of sync. Are you seeing the same thing?
Yeah, it's definitely just a slightly, just ever so slightly disjointed. And like you said, it's not, you know, blatantly bad or anything. It's just, you know, like you said, split seconds off here and there. And, you know, when it comes to an offense that's so motion predicated like SNU's is, that those split seconds here and there make a huge difference. And I think we've seen that thus far.
Yeah, and another example, the quarterback draw. When they get the ball in the red zone, first and 10 from about the 14, they run a design quarterback draw that is wide open. But, you know, the offensive line not ready for Davis's speed or quickness on the draw, and he runs into his center and falls down, right? And so instead of a potential touchdown, you have a loss of 2 yards. Just the timing issues. But those are correctable, and you think that the more they play, you know, some of those will get into a better rhythm. It seemed like, even though the first downs and the yardage wouldn't show that, it seemed like the rhythm was getting there in the second quarter a little bit more, with just the ability of having some plays that were going for more than about 2 yards. But you know, maybe they look at Gage Porter more, and he was only in on one play in the first half, and he kind of looked timid. I think his shoulder is really bothering him, but maybe we see him a little more. Maybe they just try to save him for next week, but it does seem a little off.
When he came in and ran that quarterback draw when Davis went out with losing his helmet, you could see him kind of protect himself as the tackle was inevitable. there. So it's hard to know how much of an option he really is at this point. And backing up today is Colby Entwistle, the freshman from Edmond North High School. Of course, Entwistle, freshman on the baseball team as well. Had a great first year for the Crimson Storm. But, yeah, it's just hard to know what the options are at this point other than just making a few tweaks here and there. And that was something that, you know, Coach Ada told us before the game was last week there weren't any major tweaks offensively. There were very slight minor adjustments. Plays just started happening. And, you know, maybe we see the same thing happen again.
Yeah.
But goes back to his pregame, mentions of don't wait for it. Mm-hmm. That was one of the keys he wanted to impress upon his team was don't wait for it. And, you know, if the second half comes kind of looks like it did last week, then you kind of got to wonder what you're waiting on.
Yeah, certainly. You want them to just play the way that you see them play in practice. I think that's maybe some of the hardest things about being a coach is you see when it works well, right? And you know that if they trust what they're doing, if they're relying on the person next to them, they're doing their job, that these things can have success. And as fans, I think sometimes we lose that because we just want to see the success and we don't see the little things that are happening that kind of build into those things. But as a coach, it probably drives you crazy that you know the talent is there. You saw it the second half of last week where really they had a chance to win the game. And they're well within reach in this game. Hate is certainly right. Like, don't wait. But they have waited a little bit. Maybe that's some timing issues or whatever it may be. But we need to see a better second half like we did last week from SNU. Building on some of those things, finding the things that are there. They have opportunities. They're blocking well. It's not terrible. But just finding those opportunities to make a play and then finding someone who's willing to make that play. To give a little bit of extra effort, to catch a ball for a first down, to do those things that put you in a position to score a touchdown or to get closer to the end zone than midfield where they've been kind of hanging out all day.
Let's go over the first half stats for you. In halftime, 13-3, Ouachita with the lead. First downs, Ouachita 11, SNU 2. As far as running the football, 184 yards on the ground for Ouachita this afternoon on 34 carries. 39 passing yards, 3 of 5 through the air is Grant Allen. 39 plays, 223 yards of total offense for Ouachita this afternoon, just under 6 yards per play thus far. SNU, 10 carries, 20 rushing yards. Jarvis Davis, 2 for 10 through the air, 11 yards. 31 total yards for SNU in that first half on 20 plays, just a yard and a half per play offensively. Ryan Reed on punting, 5 punts this afternoon, 45 and a half yards per average. Individually for SNU, Jarvis Davis, 11 yards rushing, 8 yards for Jarrell Farr, and 4 yards for Angel Ramirez. Rounding out the rushing, Jaron Alvarado has 1 catch for 7, and Aaron Fellows, 1 catch for 4 yards. Rounding out the offensive numbers for SNU. For Ouachita, Kendall Givens, 11 carries, 100 yards, and a touchdown. Of course, had that long 56-yard run late in the first half. TJ Cole has carried at the bulk of the time, 17 carries, 85 yards. Should have had a touchdown, but got a little showboaty as he was going into the end zone and got flagged for it. Connor Flanagan, 1 carry for 8 yards, and Zaylin Falls, 2 carries for 4 yards. Again, Grant Allen, 3 for 5, 39 yards. He's been sacked once by Landon Walker. Hunter Swoboda, 1 catch, 24 yards. Hayden Waller, 1 catch, 8 yards. And Connor Flanagan, 1 catch for 7 yards. Individually, defensively, Jamarik Waller, 3 tackles and a tackle for loss for Ouachita. Terrell Gibson, 2 tackles and a tackle for loss. And he was the one who forced the Jarvis Davis fumble on the goal line as well. And Rovell Carter was the one who had the fumble recovery for the touchdown for Ouachita. Trent Smith and Elijah Calhoun, each with 7 tackles individually for the Crimson Storm. And Trent Smith had the forced fumble on the goal line of Kendall Givens. Holden Hill starting today in place of Dorian Harris. He has 5 tackles for the freshman, including a tackle for loss. Landon Walker has been outstanding today. 3 tackles, 1 sack, 2 total tackles for loss, and he has been in the backfield a lot today. Aaron Randall, 3 tackles and a tackle for loss. And Cole Cizik, 4 tackles for the Crimson Storm. We'll take another quick break, and when we come back, we will look ahead to the second half and get the second half underway here in Bethany. Again, no other conference scores to pass along. All other games in the conference tonight at 6 o'clock. And again, just a reminder, Arkansas Tech at East Central tonight. We will be in Ada next week for a 6 o'clock kickoff for the Crimson Storm and the Tigers. You can hear that game right here on Crossover Radio Sports. Harding is at Southeastern tonight. Arkansas Monticello at Oklahoma Baptist. Southwestern is at Southern Arkansas. And Northwestern is at Henderson State. So we'll take another quick break, and when we come back, we'll have the second half keys and the start of the second half here in Bethany. This is SNU Football, brought to you by Edmund Air Conditioning, Heating, and Plumbing. Welcome back to Bethany, the start of the second half, just moments away between the Crimson Storm and the Ouachita Baptist Tigers. Luke McConnell, Landry Franks with you here on the SNU Athletics live stream on YouTube, as well as Crossover Radio Sports over the air. Thanks for joining us this afternoon for Southern Nazarene football. Landry, as we get the second half started, your keys for the second half for SNU.
Yeah, well, offensively, I still want to see Farr get involved. He was targeted 3 times on 3 different passes with no completions. Now, one of those was a corner route that was wide open. So getting him involved in the run game, even just trying to get the ball in his hands, would be one key for the offense. And obviously building consistency. We talked about that before the break. And then defensively, keep doing what you're doing. If I'm the defensive coordinator, I'm just saying keep playing hard, keep reading your keys, keep rallying to the football. They're tackling well. They're They're finding the cutback lanes. They're doing a good job. But maybe the only thing you're asking for is, hey, let's get the ball back to our offense. Let's give them more chances to go score. Luke, what about you?
Yeah, I think you just got to make those little tweaks that on offense to, you know, just get those timing correct. And again, like you said, the defense has played really well. They really have. I mean, the numbers are a little, in flux, if you will, because of that big long run and just the number of plays. But overall, I mean, I think the defense has done well, and you just need the offense to come along just a little bit more. So we have Ryan Reed kicking off left to right into the wind. Connor Flanagan, Justin Dean back deep for the Tigers. We are underway in the second half. Reed sends it high. It hangs up in the breeze. And it's going to be Isaac Edwards calling for the fair catch at the 37-yard line.
Yeah, Isaac Edwards did not look like he wanted to catch that football.
No, I wouldn't want to catch that with that sort of breeze as well. I mean, that
I don't blame him.
With, with the high pooch in a wind like this, I think that's kind of what you're going for. Is maybe you can just make a fluky play happen here. So first and 10 for the Tigers. Moving right to left in the second half, Grant Allen, the quarterback, the sophomore from Springdale. He turns and gives to Cole, and he's going to be met at about the 39-yard line. They'll give him the 40, so a gain of 3. On first down, it'll be second and 7. Grant Allen, again, sophomore quarterback, wasn't necessarily supposed to be the starter, but an injury to Riley Harms, who is out for the foreseeable future. Transfer from Nebraska Kearney put Grant Allen in the quarterback slot. Two very different physical types. Allen 6'1", 180. Harm stands 6'5". Allen's rolling to his right on second down. The pass well low for Tucker Swoboda. And Swoboda had a lot of space out there on the sideline, and just not a good throw there from Allen.
Yeah, and he's been their number one target all day. Just a little speed out, kind of boot to the outside. Felt some pressure and let go of it too soon, and one hopped it to his man.
So it'll be third down and 7, and a big opportunity for SNU just a minute into the third quarter to maybe get off the field. Hernandez coming on the blitz on the outside. Allen looking to the left. It's behind Flanagan, who had some space on the outside, but it falls incomplete. And a 3-and-out for Ouachita as SNU forces the punt.
And that's a dream start for the defense. Dream start. Decent coverage on that play. Wasn't perfect, but it wasn't bad. But two incompletions, quick punt, get the offense on the field, help them get into some rhythm. You think they send some pressure here on this punt? It's been hard for them to punt all day.
I don't know. With the wind, I don't know. Joe Couch is the punter. Slipped down on his last, no running out this time. He sends a high end-over-end kick. Roloffs lets it bounce behind him, and smartly as it bounds through the end zone for the touchback. So it'll be SNU football on offense coming out with 14:05 to go in the third quarter. We'll take a quick timeout and be back with SNU's offensive possession right after this. This is SNU football.
Hello, and welcome to our broadcast. My name is Danny Thomason, and I am the Director of Intercollegiate Athletics here at Southern Nazarene University. You know, we compete in 16 varsity sports in Division II NCAA, and we could not pull that off without the help of a lot of wonderful sponsors. And so we would like to take this opportunity during the broadcast to say thank you, thank you, thank you to so many of our wonderful sponsors that help make our athletic competitions possible. So thank you, and enjoy the remainder of the broadcast. Bolts up.
Welcome back to Bethany. SNU out on offense here in the third quarter after the defense forced a 3-and-out. 14:05 to go in the third period. Ouachita leading 13-3 over the Crimson Storm. Jarvis Davis back out there at quarterback. Fellows the man in motion. Fellows is the one who gets it. Going, trying to get outside. Cuts it upfield. And he's going to be taken down by number two there for the Tigers. That's Andrew Hayes, who tried to strip it. But Fellows went down with it before Hayes was able to get it. It'll bring up second down after no gain on first down.
Yeah, not much doing on that play. The longer he stretched it, it seemed like the more OBU defenders were able to get around the ball.
So second and 10, ball on the right hash, two wide receivers either side for the Crimson Storm. Angel Ramirez is the back beside Davis. Davis, quick out, looking for roll-offs, and Hayes came off his man to break that play up. And Hayes with a nice instinctive play there. Seemed like, you know, knew exactly what was about to happen there with roll-offs in the slot.
Yeah, and that's the number one target for SNU, Reed Roloffs, getting the ball. And I think he only has one catch so far today. A couple targets, but been pretty quiet just offensively. The offense has been a little quiet.
So third and 10 quickly with 13:22 to go in the third quarter. Three wide receivers to the left. Roloffs is on the right side. Davis fakes the give, now rolls back left, gets a nice block from Jaron Alvarado, now flows it back across the field looking for Tisdale, and it's intercepted by Hayden Lassiter. That ball just kind of hung in the air. Tisdale was open, but it didn't get there in time. There's a flag on the far side of the field.
Yes.
We'll see who this is going to be on.
Yeah, it's either...
I think we're going to get targeting on Jaron Alvarado for the blindside block there on Anthony Freeman. Remember, you cannot, you know, come back with a blindside block.
Looks like they waved the flag off.
Looks like they picked it up.
That would have been, if that would have been on Alvarado, you know, if it's targeting, he's done for the day. He's also their deep snapper.
Yes,
so you really need that not to be the case.
Less than ideal. So the interception by Lassiter gives the Tigers excellent field position inside the SNU 30 at the 29-yard line with 13:12 to go in the quarter. Allen swings it out. Wide open is Connor Flanagan, and he is going to coast in for the touchdown. Flanagan came in motion, and nobody went with him to the right side of the formation. And Flanagan cruises in for the 29-yard touchdown reception just like that.
Yeah, that's a first big mental bust we've really seen from the defense all day. And that's one you just can't have. You know, you have a motion. I'm guessing they're in man on that play. Someone's got to go with them, or someone's got to tell someone to switch because there was not a soul within 15 yards of them.
Yes, and you had looked like three safeties out on the field, and flags fly. The kick by Goodman went through the uprights. We'll see what the flags are for. It looked like the official was trying to get a pre-snap flag out. So it looks like the official said that no, it was good on the pre-snap, and the kick is good. So with 13:03 to go in the third quarter, it's now Ouachita 20 and SNU 3. So a tough break there, an interception, and then one play later, the Tigers find the end zone for the second time today offensively. And just like that, SNU now facing a three-score hole.
Yeah, and you start the half off with a great three and out, a great effort by the defense, just sound fundamentals. And then just unable to move the football, had some opportunities with those three plays for the offense, but just couldn't connect anything together. But still, this game is not out of reach. There's hardly any time taken away from this quarter. And if you watched any of the game last week, or maybe you were at the game, 16 should have been probably 22 points in the second half for SNU. So it's certainly not out of reach. Just need to find their rhythm. Make some of these plays happen, and catch the football too.
And that interception thrown by Davis, not a, I mean, It was the right play. Tisdale was open. It was just a long throw into the wind.
Yes.
It's just one of those where you have to have enough time and you have to just put enough on it. And just the combination, all things work together where Laster was able to come all the way over from his safety position to make the play.
Yeah, and they just were running deep crossing routes. And I'm sure in practice they probably have a play design where you throw that backside one. But in general, that's a throw that you kind of hold on to unless there is not a soul around, because that's a really hard throw. I mean, he just across the field, he's throwing that ball about 30 yards plus the distance he's throwing it down the field. So it's a really difficult throw.
Gabe Goodman sends this end over end kick away. It will chase Amon Byers through the end zone where he will take a knee. It was running like he was about to come out.
Yeah.
But thought better of it. So
yeah, or maybe Jarrell Farr told him to take a knee.
To be smart there.
I can't blame him, though. You get the ball in your hands. You want to do something.
Exactly. Exactly. Byers had several good kickoff returns last week. Mm-hmm. Showed some great speed at that position. But now SNU with the ball. Down 20-3. Offense has struggled mightily today. Just 31 yards of total offense thus far for the Crimson Storm.
Just two first downs.
So Jarvis Davis back in at quarterback. Two wide receivers to the right. Reed Rojas coming in motion to the near side. Davis will swing it out to Farr, and it goes out of bounds incomplete. That was close to a backwards pass.
Yep. Another drop. Yeah, and that was, Luke, you're on the money. I mean, it looked like fumble to me from up here, but hard to tell.
Yeah, it really was. Farr was definitely in front of him, but the pass being behind him made it tough.
Mm-hmm.
Farr in motion. Davis gives it to Schellmeyer, who trips in the backfield and loses three back to the 22-yard line. So now to bring up 3rd and 13 for SNU. SNU sideline sending in the play. And Landry, this Ouachita team, a lot of new faces, but still plenty talented.
Yes, and deep in just about every position.
Schellmeyer to the right of Davis. He's got the snap. Back to pass. Avoids the rush from McDonald. Fires it low and behind Farr as Davis was being harassed there by Rovell Carter.
Yeah, and Davis just doesn't seem nearly as comfortable as he did last week in the pocket. Just getting flushed out. He's making a little quick throws. His mechanics are they seem a little fast, so he's kind of skipping it in there. A little short, just about every time. It's hard to teach that. It's hard to coach that in the middle of the game.
It is. Dustin Hayda walking with his quarterback to the sideline. Ryan Reed to send this one away. A line drive chases Flanagan back to the 46-yard line. Flanagan hits the far sideline at the 30. Cuts inside a block at the 15. Still avoiding tacklers. Finally is going to be gang tackled inside the 10 all the way down to the 6-yard line. At the 5-yard line is where they're going to spot it. So Connor Flanagan, a huge kickoff return of 49 yards all the way down to the SNU 5-yard line. And Ouachita in business once again with 11:54 to go in the third quarter, already leading 20-3.
Yeah, and that's the danger in one of those line drive punts. He really needs to angle that to one side or the other. Instead, he hits it straight, and it's not a bad punt. It had plenty of distance on it, but no height, so you don't have any time for your coverage to get there. Gives the returner plenty of time to find a hole and run.
Givens is the Wildcat back for the Tigers. Dean, the man in motion to the left side. Low snap. Givens picks it up, runs right side, meets Josh Lopez in the hole, and Lopez bear hugs him and slings him down at the 1-yard line.
And that's a good, that's a great tackle by Lopez, because this is the kind of a moment in a football game where you can just kind of lie down and let that guy run in the end zone, not face that real physical tackle, but instead he takes that head on and prevents a touchdown.
So second and goal from the one. Grant Allen comes back in at quarterback. Givens the back behind him. He'll give it to Givens over the right side, and he cruises in to the end zone for another Ouachita Baptist Tigers touchdown. So not even 4 minutes gone by in the third quarter, and Ouachita has already tacked on two touchdowns to their lead and have extended this one to 26-3 with 11:16 to go in the third period. Goodman on for the extra point. Lassiter will hold. Hasn't been the smoothest operation all day. But this one is, and Goodman's kick is good. So with 11:16 to go in the third quarter, score now Ouachita Baptist 27 and the Crimson Storm 3. And Landry, probably the most disheartening part is, you know, not necessarily that you gave up two touchdowns, but that Ouachita was able to get two touchdowns in less than 4 minutes and have really put a damper on this one.
Yes, it's almost like coming out of halftime and then being down two more scores than you thought you were. And just not being able to move the football. I mean, that's, you know, we watch it and we want to say, well, they got to do something different. You can't just change your offense in the middle of a game.
Right.
I think that's kind of a little bit daydreaming a little bit. You know, you have to keep running your offense. You have to keep doing the things that you practice every single week. But it can be frustrating. It can be challenging when those things aren't having success. And certainly, Peta is no stranger to this offense. He's not going to try to recreate the wheel. He's not going to start running the air raid or anything like that. But they need to find some consistency.
Goodman blasts this kickoff through the end zone and out of the end zone. Got a little close to that sideline over there.
Yeah, it really did.
So SNU back on offense at their own 25-yard line. And Landry, we've seen this offense for, you know, several years now. I mean, when you're looking at it, what sort of adjustments, I mean, can you even make? Obviously, you can't change the system completely.
Mm-hmm, right.
But what are some tweaks that you think you can make to try to just at least, if nothing else, get some positive yards and some positive plays and start stringing together a first down or two?
Yeah, it's tricky. You know, they had real success with the bubble last week. They had no success today with the bubble. And we haven't really seen the running backs get the ball much, but when they've had the ball, they haven't done much with it.
The give is to Farr, trying to get outside, but Terrell Gibson is there, making the play in the backfield for a loss of 4.
You know, one thing that you certainly can do just to help your defense out, you know, last drive, you ran the ball, and then pass incomplete, and only spent about, you know, 25, 30 seconds off the clock. Maybe Hayda right here slows his offense down, even though they're down, just slowing the offense down just to give your defense some kind of a reprieve. But then, too, on special teams, you have to be able to rally and make that tackle. You can't give the ball up on your own 5.
Gage Porter is out there as part of a diamond package. Davis will give it to Porter. Makes a man miss in the hole, runs across the 20, and gets up to the 23-yard line for a gain of 2. He lost his helmet again, so he has to come out of the play.
Yeah, 2 plays, 2 helmet losses. Still looked a little timid in the hole. You know, Gage is such a hard runner, you can tell. Just something's just a little off with his arm or shoulder today.
So third down and 12 from their own 23-yard line. Davis back to pass. Looking to the left side, and it's dropped once more. This time it was Dalton Sanders who had the ball in his hands and was unable to come up with the catch. Lavery Shepard, slow to get up for the Tigers, and he walks off kind of dangling that left arm. That's third or fourth player that we've seen go off today with some sort of shoulder injury today.
Yes.
Both sides.
Yeah, and you see a droopy shoulder like that. That's not normally something you want to see, so hopefully he's all right and going to get treated right now.
So Ryan Reed back on to punt. 49-yard return for Connor Flanagan, last time out.
Looks like they might be sending some pressure here.
Reed sends us one again. Angled that one much better this time. It bounces at the 40, takes a sideways hop, and goes out of play at the Ouachita 39-yard line.
You live with that punt.
Yes, that is a more than satisfactory punt into that sort of breeze. If you can get 30-plus mm-hmm. yards on a kick in like that, that's some good work there.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, the last one was, like I was saying, it's a good punt. Just kicking it right to the guys, usually never ideal.
So the SNU defense back out there. Despite the score and the numbers, they have played well. Grant Allen is the quarterback, and we've got a flag. Nope, timeout is going to be the call. And we'll take timeout too. 9:44 to go in the third quarter. It's Ouachita 27 and SNU 3. This is SNU Football, brought to you by Edmund Air Conditioning, Heating, and Plumbing.
Wonder where the capital A in Chick-fil-A came from? It started with grade A, top quality chicken. But we believed everything, not just the food, should be grade A. A is for all the little things we do to bring you our best every day.
To me, the A in Chick-fil-A is a smile. I want to give the guests a little encouragement, maybe just a little joke that makes them laugh when they come through the drive-thru. We can stay 6 feet apart and have the best air high five.
Welcome back to Bethany. Back to action we go. Kamontre McKnight on the carry, and he will carry across midfield down to the SNU 47-yard line for a first down for Ouachita Baptist.
There's a flag down on the 40. Looks like a hold on one of the wide receivers, maybe number 13, Swoboda.
It will be on the younger Swoboda.
That's right.
Maybe could take some tips from Big Brother Hunter. That one goes on Tucker Swoboda. So wipe out the 14-yard gain and back it up 10 yards. So it'll be first and 20 now for the Tigers.
You got to know, brothers.
First and 19 as they spot it at the 30.
A brother who's a wide receiver and a brother who's a tight end. You know they practice blocking.
Oh, no doubt.
Open field blocking.
No doubt. Allen's the quarterback, T.J. Cole in the backfield for the Tigers. Give us to Cole, up the middle, makes a cut to the right side, is met hard by Eli Calhoun. Gain of 4 on first down. It'll be second and 15 at their own 34-yard line. We both thought, watching the tape, that Calhoun had a bit of a tough game last week at Monticello, yeah. But he's played well today.
Yes, he's played much better, and some of that is probably just settling in. First game, it's, you know, as much as you want to say, yeah, you played before or whatever, you watch an NFL game, you're going to watch it tomorrow. They just make mistakes just because it's the first game, and you're just trying to make too many plays. But he's definitely settled in, made some good plays.
So Boda, the man in motion, 3 wide receivers left.
Yeah, false start.
And a false start is going to be the call on the Tigers.
Looks like it was on Cole, the running back. Just a little fast. Those false starts on the running back, they always make me think, did I see something? Was that wrong? Something looked just a little off, and certainly he was off.
So back it up to second and 20 now with 8:22 to go in the third quarter.
You got to make some of this right here, second
yes,
and 20.
Yes, got to get a yeah. stop. 2 wide receivers to either side. Cole is the running back in the backfield with Allen. Allen back to pass. Blitz comes. Allen looking down the far side. Over for Swoboda. It's intercepted. Cameron Wells got in front of Hunter Swoboda. And a fantastic defensive play by Cam Wells the sophomore.
Man, that he just high-pointed the football, right? It's not a bad pass. It's not a great pass, but it's not a bad pass. It's just a good play. He out-wrestled the wide receiver, Swoboda, to come down with the ball. And in a game where you're trying to get some momentum going, those are the kind of plays that you need to see happen. After giving up two quick touchdowns, get the ball back, get your offense on the field in position, decent position, instead of inside their own 25, pushing midfield right here.
And can this big play be a spark for this SNU offense?
Mm-hmm.
Gage Porter back out there as a running back. Jarvis Davis, the quarterback. Two wide receivers left, roll-offs to the right. Asa Robertson in motion. The give is to Porter up the middle, and he's banged down hard after a gain of one.
Looks like they were just, in the spread, or pistol, they're really just running kind of a triple option, kind of a half-motion, wing-T-looking formation.
Porter comes off. Angel Ramirez back out there as the running back. Robertson to the top of the formation. Davis swings it out to Roloffs. Good block by Robertson. Roloffs gains about five up to the 47-yard line.
This is a key third down, Luke.
Yes.
Because you've had two plays where it's third and five, right? Don't get me wrong, but you've had two plays where you've moved the ball forward and you are in rhythm, a pass that was on the money, a play that you run all the time in bubble. Now you have a third and five. You got to get a first down here.
Two wide either side. Davis checks to the sideline. Still 15 on the play clock. Davis, back to pass. Quarterback draw all the way. Follows his blockers patiently. He's got the first down. Big gain for Jarvis Davis. Give him 10 down to the 43-yard line of Ouachita and the Crimson Storm with their first down of the second half. 6:43 and counting.
You got to love it.
Three wide to the left side now. Davis takes the snap. They swing it out to Robertson. It was a backwards pass, and it goes, and Robertson covers it up at the 49-yard line. No question about that one.
Yes. And again, it was there. It's not a good pass. It was behind him. But that bubble is there. They have the matchup they want. That's why they like running it into the boundary. They can block easier. But they got to complete the pass.
Second and 16 now. Davis checks to the sideline. Still 15 on the play clock. 6 minutes to go, third quarter, 27-3. Ouachita Baptist with the lead over SNU. Jarvis Davis has gone the distance today at quarterback. He'll roll right, and a flag and a false start coming up on the SNU offensive line thrown by the umpire there. So you get the first down. And then immediately go backwards.
Yeah, they're back to where they started on the third down play.
So it'll be now second and 21 at the SNU 46-yard line.
Man, that was on the center. But you don't see that very often. Carry on.
Two wide either side. Ramirez the back beside Davis. Davis back to pass. Got time. Finds a wide open Robertson at the 40-yard line. He's immediately hit and tackled there by number 7, Dante Gibson. But they'll give him forward progress to the 39-yard line, where it will bring up a third and a manageable 6.
Yeah, and this is probably two down territory right here. Getting a good spot.
Yes, and your offense a little frustrated. They've been trying to go a little bit quicker tempo on this series. And Davis will check to the sideline. 20 on the play clock. Under 5 minutes to go, third quarter. SNU trying to put together a drive here, down 27-3. Davis has it. Back to pass. Got some time. Now runs out of it and is going to be belted down. My number 5, that's Jacoby Nolan, a freshman linebacker from Prescott, Arkansas. And that will bring up fourth down at the Ouachita 42-yard line. It'll be fourth and 9.
Yeah, and
it looks like they're leaving the offense out there. Nope, they're bringing Ryan Reed on now.
Yeah, you know, maybe fourth and five, you go for that, but you can't put your defense in that spot when you can really flip the field right here. You know, the pocket was there. He seemed a little skittish when he felt some pressure. You know, I don't know if there just wasn't anyone open, but that's a better drive. At least some momentum going forward, doing the right things. Just need to clean up some of those passes.
Looks like Dustin Hayda is going to burn a timeout here. We will take timeout as well with 3:54 to go in the third quarter. 27-3, Ouachita Baptist with the lead. We'll be right back after this. This is SNU Football brought to you by Edmund Air Conditioning, Heating, and Plumbing. Welcome back to Bethany. Ryan Reed on to punt. The snap is high. Gets over his head. He chases it all the way back to the 30. Now he's going to have to hurry. Fumbled it again. Now he's going to have to run. And he's going to be taken down at the 30-yard line. So a wide snap, a little bit wide. That slipped through the hands of Ryan Reed. And instead of flipping the field, Ouachita going to take over at the SNU 30-yard line.
Yeah, that's tough. Yeah, I don't know what else more to say about that.
Yeah.
Defense has played well. Certainly they can back him up, get him out of field goal range. But big challenge. New quarterback in.
New quarterback in for the Tigers. It's Evi Livingston, the freshman from Batesville, Arkansas. As it appears, Grant Allen's day is done. Looks like everybody else still out there with the starters. A quick flip to Kamontre McKnight, trying to find space on the right side. Trent Smith and Elijah Calhoun hold on to him at the 28, but he pushes the pile all the way down inside the 25 to the 23. Seems to be plenty of chirping going on out there both ways right now for whatever reason.
Mm-hmm.
But second, and it'll bring up second and three at the 23-yard line. So SNU unable to do too much with the interception by Cam Wells. McKnight in motion. The give is to Cole on the right side. Josh Lopez holding on after the gain of six down to the 17-yard line. It'll be a first down for the Tigers as we're under 3 minutes to go third quarter.
It's interesting quarterback change. Maybe they're just trying to protect Allen. Maybe they just got sick of him skipping it in there, but either way, it seems like an odd time for a quarterback change.
First and 10, ball at the right hash. Livingston turns, gives it to Cole, who stumbled and kind of fell head first into the line. Just a gain of three or two down to the 15. It'll be second and eight.
Yeah, and there's Lopez again, just getting in there and making a play. He has, and Hayter was right. I mean, he's probably going to lead the team in tackles again today. I mean, he just has a nose for the football. And they send him on blitzes quite a bit, but he's playing well.
Second and eight, 2 minutes to go, third quarter. Livingston turns and gives to Cole. Fumble the football! Who's got it? And I think the Tigers fell on it. It looks like from our vantage point that the Tigers fell on it. I think Jack Pillow was down there and got it.
Yeah, clock's running, so staying with the Tigers. Unfortunate, I think it went through about three or four SNU defenders' hands.
Yep. I think so as well. And a fumble forward, too. So ended up gaining 7 yards on the play. So it'll be third and one from the 8-yard line. They run Givens out there as the Wildcat quarterback. Dylan Bauer coming back onto the field for SNU.
That's good to see.
Very good to see. And out with a looked like a shoulder injury in the first half. Givens hiding behind his blockers, cuts inside and cuts back across the formation and scores a touchdown. As the Tigers extend their lead with 1:11 to go in the third quarter. Now 33-3, Ouachita Baptist. Gabe Goodman on to attempt the extra point here with 1:11 to go in the third period, and it is up and good. So SNU now trailing 34-3. Again, other games across the conference all kicking off later this evening at 6 o'clock. Arkansas Tech down in Ada at East Central. Harding will be in Durant at Southeastern. Monticello is over in Shawnee against Oklahoma Baptist. Southwestern making the trek over to Magnolia to take on Southern Arkansas. And Northwestern will head over to Arkadelphia to take on the Henderson State Reddies. Just a reminder, we will be in Ada next Saturday night, 6 o'clock kickoff from East Central. We'll be on the air about 5:30, 5:45 or so here on Crossover Radio Sports, where you can tune in for all SNU football games, home and away, this season. Again, 6 o'clock kickoff from Ada next week. Gabe Goodman set to send this one away and drives this one through the end zone once again. And, you know, I kind of get just a little sad watching Amon Byers back there, because he wants to return one so bad.
You can
so
see
bad.
It.
You can just see it. He's like, I'm just waiting for the fourth quarter, man. Just wait.
That's right. Yeah, make him kick into the wind. Yeah, and when your specialty is kickoff returning, and you've had all of them go over your head today, it's gotta be a little painful. Good opportunity for SNU to build some confidence and momentum right here after getting a first down last drive.
Two wide receivers either side. Farr comes in motion to the near side. Davis rolls that way. Flings it back, and it's nearly intercepted by Hayes, who came off his receiver. And a flag is going to be thrown, and I think they're going to get roughing the passer potentially here.
Yeah, and Davis doesn't have to come out for that. If his helmet is taken off by a penalty, he can stay in the game. So it looks like he's going back on. You know, that's a good play call.
Oh, it is?
Wow. What number?
I didn't catch the number.
Let's see, 29's coming out, so looks like his day is done.
Yep, it would appear that 29 was the guilty party there.
And that long
Jordan Roseboro.
That last play was just a little, is this an out and a search route in the middle, which is the inside receiver's going to come out and then back in and kind of run like a little hook and sit in a zone. And the search route was wide open. But Davis obviously going for his favorite target in Rolos, which I don't blame him, but the tight end was, Alvarado was just wide open in the middle of the field. So, you know, it's a coaching thing. When you watch film tomorrow, you're going to see that pretty clearly, that there's an opportunity to make an easier pass. But for a guy who's really just taking his second full game on, those are things that he can clean up.
I think the official just said that there was no targeting, just roughing the passer. Davis is back to pass, swings it out for Schellmeyer, and it's wide of him. It falls incomplete. It'll be 2nd and 10 from the SNU 40-yard line with a minute to go in the third quarter.
And again, it's a bubble route. It's there. It's there. But first things first.
Now, got to have an accurate pass. And like we both thought, you know, Davis looked poised, confident last week, but has been fairly erratic. And, you know, when there's some pressure in your face, you can start to see some ghosts a little bit.
Right.
Two wide receivers right, one to the left, ball on the left hash. Davis turns and gives to Schellmeyer. Makes a man miss in the hole. Good hard running for Christian Schellmeyer, and he gets all the way up to the 44-yard line.
Yeah, I feel like we haven't said Christian Schellmeyer's name hardly at all today.
Didn't play at all last week. That was his first carry of the day. Had 20 carries and two receptions back in 2019.
Yeah, and he's a good hard runner, quick guy. Has good hands out of the backfield.
So third and six. Again, a manageable distance here for SNU from the 44. Davis fakes the give to Farr. Quarterback sneak up the middle, and he's not going to get there. He's going to get to the 49-yard line where it will be fourth and one. And a timeout going to be called by Ouachita, I would imagine, to preserve some time. There's 20 seconds here. They wanted to keep the wind for this punt, I would imagine.
That's right. And of course the I don't know that you punt here.
I don't either. Down 34-3.
Yeah, and I mean certainly doesn't, if you don't get it, certainly doesn't help your defense out, but you got to take a risk every now and then. That's one thing Hayes said, and you know, when we talked to him this week, that he was not afraid to take risks when they made sense, and this seems to be like an opportunity for that. I can't see if the punting team or the punting unit is on. It looks like the offense is in the huddle. But, you know, I'm a little risky, so I always like to go for it on opportunities like this. But do you have any thoughts?
Oh, no, I'm right there with you. I think fourth and one, down 34-3. You tell your guys, this is a moment. It might not win us the game, but this is a moment where you can prove some mettle here, get a yard against a really good team, a really good front, and say, hey, go win a one-on-one matchup, offensive line.
Yep. QB sneak here.
Yep, nobody over the center. Davis checks to the sideline, still 15 on the play clock. Everybody in tight here.
Wing T.
On fourth and one. The give is to Carlos Thomas. He stood up at the line of scrimmage, and he did not get it. And he is shoved unceremoniously backward.
We have a referee's hat off. I don't know if that's just the wind.
Yeah, I don't know.
Or if there's a couple penalties that we didn't see.
Yeah, I think he just threw it off. So Thomas got stuffed there. The redshirt freshman from Mustang had three carries for 17 yards last week, but couldn't get the job done there. And a nice play there on the outside by number 42, Mikey Gonzalez, freshman from Tampa. So Ouachita takes over first and 10 in SNU territory. Livingston remains the quarterback for the Tigers, but Cole remains the running back. And a flag here thrown by the line judge. We're going to get a false start on the Tigers.
Look, I'll tell you this. This has looked like a week two football game. A little sloppy. Lots of penalties, just and not even penalties that you kind of expect in a football game, like a pass interference. You know, there's been some holding, but just false starts, illegal formations, a bunch of timeouts have been taken for near delay of games. Just a little sloppy from both sides.
That's now 10 penalties for Ouachita for 105 yards this afternoon. Ouachita sitting at 285 yards of offense. SNU, a cool 20. Kamontre McKnight on the flip pass, gets across midfield, and is banged down out of play by Holden Hill at the 44-yard line. So he gains 10. It'll be second down, well, and four as they mark it at the 43-yard line. And that is how we will start the fourth quarter. After three here in Bethany in the home opener for the Crimson Storm, Ouachita leading this one 34-3. We'll take a break and be back with the start of the final stanza. This is SNU Football, brought to you by Edmund Air Conditioning, Heating, and Plumbing.
Wonder where the capital A in Chick-fil-A came from? It started with grade A, top quality chicken. But we believed everything, not just the food, should be grade A. A is for all the little things we do to bring you our best every day.
To me, the A in Chick-fil-A is a smile. I want to give the guests a little encouragement, maybe just a little joke that makes them laugh when they come through the drive-thru. We can stay 6 feet apart and have the best. best air high five.
Start of the fourth quarter here in Bethany between Ouachita Baptist and your Southern Nazarene Crimson Storm. And official timeout here. Oh, one of the officials. Not sure what happened, but he is.
Yeah.
I don't know if he got too hot or something, but he was leaning against one of the SNU players. Says he's fine. So, a little scary moment there. Always,
yeah.
Always worrisome when the officials get hit. I mean, they're they're just as, I mean, maybe not just as likely, but they're in the field of play without the helmets and pads.
Exactly. Yeah, he seems to be doing all right. I don't know if he ran into someone or... Who knows?
Second and four. The give is to Falls. Running left, cuts it back up. He's going to go down at the 40-yard line. Cam Wells in on the tackle for the Crimson Storm. Josh Lopez in there as well. DeMarcus Hawkins looked like he was last up off the bottom.
Getting a line shift almost at defensive line right now. Three in, three out.
Well, and again, we mentioned it before. That's something that was not, SNU was not, they were not able to do that back in 2019. Or if they did, it wasn't necessarily effective. Givens on third and one is the Wildcat back, running right, cuts it back, leaps, tries to leap over the pile, and he did not get it. Turned aside. He'll be short, and that'll bring up fourth down and inches.
Yeah, and, you know, that's a coaching moment for the freshman Givens, you know, on a play like that. Very rarely do you want to leave your feet, because when you leave your feet, you lose the momentum that you have. But, man, way to fit by the SNU defense, pushing that pile back. Fourth and inches right here, opportunity to get the ball back to the offense.
SNU brings in the four-man lineup. Four down linemen here. Allen turns, gives to Givens, and he doesn't get it! Oh, and he spins away! Initial contact, he did not get it, but he was able to spin and get just enough momentum to fall across the line to gain. But a great job by Cole Cizek. I think Marcus Sal was in there as well. Initial contact, he did not get it, but just able to fall forward.
Yeah, he's a great effort, making up for the last play, but man, it was a good fit. Just unable to keep those feet moving.
So a first down and 10 for Ouachita at the 39. Livingston back in at quarterback. 10 on the play clock, 13 minutes to go in the game. To give us to Falls, running left, trying to bounce outside. Harsh stiff arm to Cam Wells, who shoves him out of bounds at the 34-yard line. Gain of 5, it'll be second and 5.
If you're, you know, watching the defense right now, it was a tough third quarter for them. They're not playing poorly. They're kind of put in some difficult positions with the punt over the guy's head and then a return to the five. But they're playing hard and physical, and you gotta love that.
Two wide receivers right, tight end either side of the formation. Livingston back to pass. He's in trouble. Mason Williams missed the sack, and now Livingston has space down the left side. Cuts inside at the 10. Upended at the 5-yard line. Livingston back to pass. Mason Williams had him dead to rights in the backfield. Couldn't make the sack. And now it looks like Trent Smith, I believe, is the man down for SNU at the 5-yard line. His training staff runs out to attend to him, but Livingston just got away from the pressure and found that there was nothing over there on the left side. So 12:46 to go The Tigers now have it first and goal at the 5.
Mason Williams, correct me if I'm wrong here, Luke, was the Crimson Storm player that applied the pressure on after the play action.
Yes.
And he was in great position, and that's really hard. You're asking a nose guard to break down and make essentially an open field tackle on a mobile quarterback. It's not an easy thing to do, and certainly a coachable opportunity for him when they look at the film. But it is a play that, you know, really would have turned the tide of that this series. You know, they have first and five. Or first and goal from the 5, I should say, instead of, you know, a sack near the 40. So a little bit of a frustrating play, but a really hard play to make. We can sit and watch it and say, oh, he should have just broken down and made that tackle. But when you play nose guard and you see a quick guy and you have to break down quickly, make a decision quickly to grab his feet, that's a challenging play.
Yeah, it's hard to... Hard to move a lot of momentum ways. Trent Smith able to walk off under his own power, so that's good to see. Hopefully he will be all right. The Tigers have it now, first and goal at the 5-yard line, 12:46 to play in this one, the home opener. We've had a great crowd on hand this afternoon, pretty much full stands. Halftime was going to be a bustle of activity today. It's a lot of excitement here. It's been a tough day for the Crimson Storm, though, against the number 11 team in the country. TJ Cole is the Wildcat back, getting the snap. Isaac Givens beside him. Cole will run left, and he is taken down at the 4-yard line. Gained just 1. Nice job of penetration there. Mason Williams again making a nice play. And again, Landry, it's really hard to overstate just the difference we're starting to see. You just look at the roster and just see some of the heights and weights on these guys who are out there playing consistently.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it's a big difference. It really is.
Yeah, I mean, and if you're familiar with SNU football, size has not been a most important at all times.
Allen back in at quarterback. He turns and gives to Cole. Cole barrels into the end zone for the touchdown, and the Tigers extend their lead to 40-3 with 11:44 to play in this one.
This looks like a tired defense out there.
Trent Smith coming back onto the field, so good to see that he is all right and able to continue. Goodman's kick is up and good. Line judge threw a flag, I would imagine, for illegal participation as DeMarcus Hawkins was late coming up. Nope, they pick it up. So with 11:44 to play, the Tigers lead this one 41-3. And we'll keep it here for the moment.
Yeah, and you can, you know, I said it, you could tell it's week 2 because it's a little sloppy. Same for the refs. I think that's the third or fourth flag we've seen picked up, which is not always a bad thing, obviously, in jest. I'm giving them a hard time, but it's looked like a week 2 out there for sure. A windy, hot week 2.
So the Crimson Storm with the wind at their backs here in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, and you know, Hayda talked about culture building, you know, the last really 2 years that they've been this team, this unit, without playing a real meaningful football game. It's been culture building, and we saw it a lot last week. Even though the score is a little bloated in OBU's favor, this is a culture building moment. How are you going to respond? How are you going to work together when it's been really challenging all day?
Goodman with the high kick, and Byers is going to get a chance. From the 13-yard line, he's running right, trying to hit the outside, hits the edge, and runs out of bounds at the 25-yard line.
You know, it's hard to see from up here, but when I watched film this week, they ran 3 kickoff returns, essentially middle wedge, which is trying to hit straight down the middle of the field. They ran 1, maybe 2, to the right, which is what he did just then. That looked like a middle wedge, and so I don't know if he, I don't know, blocking-wise, if he just saw some space on the outside or thought maybe his speed could get there, but it looked like there was a little bit more of a seam in the middle, but I don't know. I'm not the special teams coach. I'll let him worry about that.
It's Jarvis Davis still out there as the quarterback. He's gone the distance today with Gage Porter out. Roloff's the man in motion. Delayed handoff up the middle. I believe that was Ramirez who was stuck after a gain of 1 to the 26. Oh, excuse me, that was Carlos Cepeda, the redshirt freshman from Ponder, Texas.
And Dawson Miller making the play on that. It's right in there. Oh, excuse me, Josh Berman.
So second down and 9. Three wide receivers to the left, one to the right. Robertson, the man in motion. Jarvis Davis with the keeper. Makes a nice cut in the hole. Crosses the 35-yard line and gets out to the 37. Nice patient run there by Jarvis Davis to pick up the first down.
Yeah, and the last drive, it looked like he tweaked his ankle a little bit on one of those tackles, and same kind of thing as he's falling down, kind of gets yanked on a little bit, walking a little gingerly, but seems to be fine.
Three wide receivers right. Cepeda to the right of Davis as well. Davis quickly swings it out, and it hits Cepeda in the back as he was getting out to block for Roloffs. And that bubble screen just has not been there for SNU today for a variety of reasons, but it seems to be accuracy has been the biggest one.
Yes, which is frustrating. Yeah, again, it's football is one of those, just any sport, it's easy to watch and say, do this or this. They just need to make those bubble screens work. But a bubble screen, when you lose confidence in throwing that quick little catch and release throw, it can really get in your mind. So you do that a couple times in the game, then it becomes really hard to throw that.
Davis fakes the sweep to Robertson, now bounces it outside. He's in trouble. And he's taken down back at the 35-yard line. A loss of 3 on the carry for Davis. And again, like you said, he's hobbling around a little bit himself. And not what you want to see with both your first and second string quarterbacks dealing with nicks and injuries already this early in the season.
Yeah, and you know, there's going to be people who are going to want them to be throwing the ball more right now. One, you need to keep the clock going, but two, like we said, you just can't change your offense, and this is what they have been doing for so long.
Third and 13, Davis back to pass, finds space up the middle, and he's going to be belted down at the 40-yard line, loses his helmet. As he gets up to the 40, it'll bring up 4th and 8, and SNU will punt it away with 9:32 to play in the ball game, with Ouachita leading 41-3. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I thought 35 Burnham was the one who got ejected for targeting.
Yeah, I have no idea.
If that was rescinded, no one said anything. Flanagan calls for the fair catch, a high booming kick from Reed. Fair caught at the 14-yard line. And that is where Ouachita will take over 1st and 10. Weird, because we had the roughing the passer with targeting was, I think, rescinded. Or the targeting portion of that was rescinded. But on the kickoff return, I don't believe that one was ever rescinded, at least not verbally. And so, guess... Oh, well.
Yeah, I'm not sure what that was about. I mean, I know they took one back for on the tight end. They kind of picked that one up, but not sure.
So, again, we will be in Ada next week. 6 o'clock kickoff against East Central. Tigers in action today, hosting Arkansas Tech, who comes in 0-1 after a home loss to Southeastern last week. East Central was shut out by Harding in week one, so they're looking for their first win of the season. Livingston is the quarterback. Several more backups along the offensive line and in the backfield for the Tigers. Livingston turns and gives to Givens along the right side. Breaks through the line and is taken down by Nichols for SNU up at the 25-yard line. A gain of 11 and a first down for the Tigers.
And brand new offense out there for the Tigers.
Excuse me, Isaac Edwards, 6'2", 15 from Hawkins, Texas.
Hawkins, Texas just sounds like it's really hot.
You it know? Does. Watch it be in like Northeast Texas.
Yeah, right.
Wide receiver either side. Livingston turns and gives to Edwards. Again, making men miss, running hard through the middle of that SNU defense. He'll gain 9. And they'll give him full 10 up to the 35.
Yeah, it didn't look like he got the first down there, but what do we know?
Crimson Storm with, looks like most of their second unit guys out there.
Yeah, I'm getting some reps for those other guys. You never know. You know, when you look at the two deep at the beginning of the season, you don't always think you're going to play. It just takes one injury.
Livingston turns and gives to Edwards again. Running hard into the middle, taken down there by number 34 for SNU. That's Casey Kennedy, freshman from Jacksonville, Texas.
And really, if you're third string, you know, you can be playing, you can be thinking about not suiting up, and then all of a sudden you're playing that game.
7:24 and counting. Tigers lead this one 41-3. The Tigers' defense has been stout, to say the least, against this SNU offense today. It's going to be Edwards again, runs through Nichols, and he'll have enough for the first down at the 45-yard line. Tigers approaching 300 yards rushing on the ground today. SNU net yards just 5 on the ground for SNU. It's been a rough day. SNU less than 50 yards of total offense, according to our stats here. It's been tough to get anything going.
Yeah, you can't overcome that, you know.
And not to coat everything in crimson-colored glasses, but, you know, we've been very impressed with what the defense has done, given everything.
Yeah.
Edwards, again, a hard run across midfield to the 49 of SNU.
Yeah, and if you're watching the game or listening later, you missed a first half where up until right before halftime, it was 6-3. You know, it was a really, really close game. And even offensively, you know, they only had a couple first downs in the first half, which even me saying that out loud sounds kind of crazy, but there was, it seemed like a back and forth game. It didn't seem certainly as one-sided as it is now.
Second and 4 from the SNU 49-yard line. Edwards again up the middle, battering his way, and he's taken down after a gain of just 1 to the 48. Trey Nichols again on the play along with Landon Walker. So third down and 3 for the Tigers, 5.5 minutes to play.
Looks like here comes that Wildcat formation with a new back. The OBU just doing what they keep doing, you know, nothing new. Put a new offense out there, run the exact same plays, nothing different. I say that, and they line up wrong. So.
Looked like they were missing a guy. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yep, just 10 guys out there. Yep. Somebody was missing. So a timeout on the field. We will take timeout as well. Just a short break here and be back right after this. This is SNU Football.
Wonder where the capital A in Chick-fil-A came from? It started with grade A top quality chicken. But we believed everything, not just the food, should be grade A. A is for all the little things we do to bring you our best every day.
To me, the A in Chick-fil-A is a smile. I want to give the guests a little encouragement, maybe just a little joke that makes them laugh when they come through the drive-thru. We can stay 6 feet apart and have the best air high five.
Welcome back to Bethany. Third and three for the Tigers. Here in the waning moments of the final stanza, 5 minutes and change to play. 41-3, Ouachita leading Southern Nazarene. Isaac Edwards in the Wildcat formation. And that's going to be a false start on the left guard. Number 60, Noah Pratt, Pruitt, leaning back a little in his stance. He was ready to pull.
That's right.
He was ready to pull. Pulled a little early.
Hey, that you laugh. You know, as coaching high school football, that was one thing that we certainly had to coach. Like, when you're pulling, just sit in there. You know, you don't. It's okay. You're gonna get there. Thinking about too much.
That makes it third and eight. They'll keep the Wildcat formation. Man in motion to the top of the formation. Ball on the left hash. Edwards gets it, follows his blocks. And he somehow got through. I don't even know how got through that. Holden Hill takes him down at the 44-yard line.
And there was a cloud of people.
I have no idea.
Both OBU and SNU, it seemed like all 22 people were in a pile. And then all of a sudden, he
popped out. The helmet that I was watching that I thought was his clearly, obviously, was not him.
Yes. I didn't even think that was him. Thought it was just someone falling, tripping.
Amazing.
Good hard run. I mean, if you're OBU, you got to love that your third running back is running this hard.
And if you're everybody else, you're like, great.
Yes.
Great.
Even their third is that good.
First and 10 at the 44. Edwards again, banging down for a gain of about two there to the 42-yard line. 4.5 minutes to play. Tigers well over 300 yards rushing now.
You think when OBU recruits, they just tell every wide receiver that they're eventually going to have to play tight end, or?
I don't know. Unless you're Allie Freeman.
That's right. Yeah.
Unless you're short and fast.
That's right.
The short, quick ones, you can stay. Everybody else, be ready. Second and eight, Livingston turns and gives to Falls, trying to bounce it outside, and a nice tackle in the backfield there. See who that is getting off the bottom of the pile for SNU. Number 34, Josh Kennedy.
And sometimes
Casey Kennedy, excuse me.
You just got to hang on for dear life. That's what he did there. Just grabbed a piece of that jersey and was kind of out of position to make the play, but just got a little bit hung on.
So third and eight, 3:20 and counting here for Ouachita with a 41-3 lead. Livingston takes the snap, gives to Falls running right, picking his way across the 40, and he's taken down at the 39-yard line. Kennedy again in on the stop, along with number 38, Colton Morris, freshman from Cypress, Texas. So that'll bring up fourth down. Ouachita going to leave the offense on the field under 3 minutes to play. They try to just grind this clock down.
Yeah, no rush here for them.
Edwards will come back in for Falls.
You know, maybe they snap this. Maybe you just let that clock run down to zero.
It's fourth and five from the 39-yard line. Two wide receivers either side here. And a flag for offsides, and that quick slant is going to be incomplete.
But irrelevant. Looks like offsides on the defensive end for SNU.
It's going to be number 53 there. So that will give Ouachita a first down with 2:25 to play. And that might just do it if my... Well, no, now that the clock's not running. Well, it still might do it.
Time will tell.
Yeah.
Literally.
Literally.
You know, I think OBU's been doing a hard count, so either on two or on three or silent count each time. Beginning of the game, the first team, first stringers were kind of jumping off sides too.
Edwards met in the backfield. Cole Cizik got back there and made a nice play, and now a flag is going to be thrown. I believe that's going to go on Aaron Randall.
Yeah, he's got to be a little smarter than that. You know, end of the game, frustrations are high. I get it. No one likes losing. But when you're getting off the pile, I can't shove someone's helmet back into the ground.
Yeah, just – and that, you know, and that's a young player making a mistake. And
yeah.
Something that they'll learn from.
Mm-hmm.
Kennedy runs off. Cole McMahon into the game. Another freshman. Under 2 minutes to go. The season opener. At home here. Edwards running right. Cam Wells wraps him up around the legs and takes him down after a gain of about three. He's second down with 1:42 to play.
You know, Luke, I don't think there's been a play today on both sides of the ball without a motion of some
kind.
That
would be fascinating to go back and look. But, yeah, I would agree.
Including shifts. But even their shifts, they'll motion. You know, OBU will shift to the boundary and then bring that receiver in. I don't know that there has been a play where even on the Wildcat they're motioning. So lots of plays today. Maybe this will be the first one right here when they take a knee. But then there's no motion.
Yeah. So Livingston will take a knee as the final minute of this one will wind down as Ouachita's going to move to 2-0. SNU will drop to 0-2 in this young season. There's a lot, I would say there's a lot of potential mm-hmm. here with this Crimson Storm team.
Yep.
There's a lot of young talent, a lot of young guys who we called a lot of young names today.
Yes.
I mean, it wasn't all the Reed Roloff or mm-hmm. Gage Porter or, you know, Landon. We did call Landon Walker's name a lot.
Right.
But, you know, some of the older guys, you know, the James yes. Love or Dorian Harris, we didn't call all old guys. We called a ton of young guys' names today at making plays, not for being out of position or missing mm-hmm. a tackle or something, for making plays, making good plays. As the final moments tick off here, the final score here in Bethany in the SNU home opener, Ouachita 41 and the Crimson Storm 3, and we'll keep it here and wrap things up from Bethany. But again, a lot of young talent here. There's a lot of positives that yes. SNU can take away going forward, even though 41-3 doesn't scream.
No.
Let's take away positives.
Yes.
But there are. There are yeah. a lot of positives, and they all seem, a lot of them all seem to be individual players.
There were a lot of great efforts today, which, you got to be pleased with, and you got to look at with optimistic eyes. But, you mentioned potential. There is a ton of potential. I mean, especially as you think about, you're building a culture. Hayda's kind of first year with this team as a head coach. He's you got to have eyes down the road too. But with potential, you can have a high ceiling, but you can also have a low floor. And so this is where culture comes into play, right? So if you're gonna bank your team on your culture. Moments like this, how does this next week of practice go when you played a really, really good team and they did some things that really, really stifled you and kind of pushed you in some places that were difficult? You know, is your culture going to take root or is it going to be something that you look back on and say, man, that was just detrimental to our team? I don't think that for SNU. I think they've got a good culture here. But certainly the potential is through the roof for this team, and they should keep their heads up high, especially the performance they had in their first half.
It's always fascinating to see SNU against a team like Ouachita. Because, I mean, you look at, like, enrollment numbers, you know, the public versus private,
right.
things like that. You're like, Ouachita is basically SNU in Arkansas.
Yes.
I mean, it's about the same size, mm-hmm. even, I think, technically a bit smaller enrollment-wise, and yet this is what they've been able to build
yeah.
over the years.
Yeah.
And, you know, it's not like Ouachita has been a powerhouse for mm-hmm. for 50, 60 years either.
Right.
They built this. Todd Knight, in his 22nd season, has built this. You know, his first several years, 3-7, 4-6, you know, 3-7, 2-9.
Right.
It wasn't always good.
No.
It's not like he's been winning at a high clip for 22 years. He's been winning at a high clip for the past, you know, decade or so, and even more so this last 5-6 years when they've won 3 straight conference titles. So you look at a team, at a school like Ouachita, and think, you know, they've been able to do it. They've been able to buy in and build a big quality football powerhouse program, and you think, hey, there's not really a reason why SNU can't at least get some, to some degree, to the same level. And I think, you know, you start at the ground level, you start to see those steps with some of the players that we've seen today, some of these freshmen like a Marcus Sowell or, you know, a Josh Lopez, and, you know, offensively a Jarrell Farr. You start to see that, take that step with those young guys.
Yeah, and, you know, SNU has done this once before. So when they were playing NAIA, it was 10, 15 years of tough football. In the last 5 or 6 years, they started playing. They were almost winning conference. They went to the playoffs 1 year and should have beat Mid-America. Then the next year, they're in the NCAA. And then they take, you know, a giant leap backwards, different competition, different recruiting rules, all of this new thing. So really, you've seen the birth of a program twice. And so a culture really does matter. And it stinks for some of those players now, because they are playing, you know, a Ouachita who is well established, but there is a sense of building to a better team with consistency, and a team that certainly has some opportunities for growth, and not just 10 years from now, but even in the next couple of years, they have such great young talent that could develop into something special.
Let's run through the final numbers. Again, the final score here, 41-3. Ouachita Baptist gets the win in SNU's home opener this afternoon. Just five first downs for SNU today. Officially, 5 yards on the ground on 26 carries, 30 yards through the air, 35 total yards for SNU today. Just things were not clicking offensively for SNU. Ouachita Baptist, 313 yards on the ground, 75 through the air, total of 388 yards overall for offense. SNU had the ball just over 20 minutes in this game. Ouachita, nearly 40 minutes of time of possession. Ouachita was 5 of 13 on third down conversions. SNU just 1 of 13 on third down conversions. A couple turnovers each way, one fumble, one interception each. And penalties, though, Ouachita still had 11 penalties, 110 yards, and for SNU, 7 for 64. Individually, for SNU, Jarvis Davis, 11 carries, 33 yards on the ground officially. 2 carries, 4 yards for Angel Ramirez, 2 for 4 yards for Jarrell Farr, and Christian Schellmeyer, 3 carries, 2 yards. Jarvis Davis, 4 for 19 today, just was not accurate with the football all day, with an interception, 30 yards for him. 1 catch, 15 yards for Asa Robertson, 1 for 7 for Jaron Alvarado, 1 for 4 for Aaron Fellows, and 1 for 4 for Reed Roloffs. Ryan Reed had a nice day punting the football into a brutal wind, dealing with all that. 37 yards on his average with a long of 54, put 2 of those inside the 20. Individually for Ouachita, 16 carries, 114 yards, 3 touchdowns for Kendall Givens, 21 carries, 99 yards for TJ Cole, Isaac Edwards, 10 carries, 52 yards, and Eli Livingston had a carry for 29 yards. Grant Allen, 4 of 9 with an interception, 68 yards and a touchdown. Eli Livingston was 1 for 1 through the air for 7 yards. Receiving, Connor Flanagan, 2 catches, 36 yards and a touchdown. 1 catch for 24 yards for Hunter Swoboda. 1 catch, 8 yards for Hayden Waller. And 1 catch, 7 yards for Kimontre McKnight. Defensively for SNU, 9 tackles for Eli Calhoun, 8 for Trent Smith, 7 each for Cole Cizik and Holden Hill. And for the Tigers, Terrell Gibson and Andrew Hayes each with a pair of tackles for loss, 3 tackles each for Damian McDonald and Jamarick Waller. So Landry, as we look ahead to next week in Ada, the Crimson Storm, 6 o'clock kickoff against East Central, and I think naturally from the outside view, you're thinking, 41-3, a disheartening loss, you know, might not have had 50 yards of offense. you're thinking, man, they've really got to overcome a mental hurdle. Is there that much of a mental hurdle, or is that kind of manufactured on the outside of this?
Yeah, well, it depends on the team. I think week two, probably not. You're also playing the best team in your conference, kind of almost hands down. And you played a first half that was really good. Now, if we watched this game and the whole game, it seemed like OBU was just running away with it. Maybe you do kind of have some of that where you don't feel like you did anything right. But defensively, they played so well. And offensively, there are options there. And it's week two. And you have to think, too, offensively, they had real success last week. So it's not like they haven't had that feeling of, like, of a good game. So there's lots. Certainly there's a hurdle. Anytime you lose 41-3 and have 50 yards of offense, that's a hurdle to evaluate. But too, in football, you have to have a quick memory. You know, you watch film, and maybe you do some things Monday to kind of work out some of the kinks. But then the kind of the rule is up by Tuesday, you've forgotten about the game before. At least you're supposed to. So you want to learn what you can, but you need to move on. They have a long season ahead of them, and they have some really winnable games just right around the corner, especially this upcoming Saturday.
Yeah, the schedule does help for SNU. You've got three, you know, middle of the pack games against East Central, Southeastern, and Arkansas Tech. Two of those at home before you go to Harding. The back half of the schedule certainly pretty tough when you go to Henderson State, mm-hmm. and then host Southern Arkansas and Oklahoma Baptist to close out the season. But you hope that in that middle stretch you can, you know, you really make some big strides and be playing your best football in November is what you strive for and what you want to be doing. So that's going to do it for us here at SNU Football Stadium. Thanks for joining us over the SNU Athletics YouTube channel and on Crossover Radio Sports. Again, 6 o'clock kickoff from Ada next Saturday against East Central. You can tune in here on Crossover Radio Sports to hear the full game from the SNU side, and we hope to be with you then. For all of us here at SNU Athletics and for my partner, Landry Franks, this is Luke McConnell saying good afternoon from Bethany.